Hey everybody, it's the graveyard and I am too excited for this show, quite honestly. Like I need to dumb it down. This doesn't fit the graveyard. I need to be more like, yeah, it's 1:30. I don't know. All right, well anyways, we haven't done this in a while, so bear with us here. And by bear with us, yeah, there's no dumb joke there. It's just hang out. We're gonna have some fun here. We're gonna talk about whatever the hell we think about. Which you guys got things? Hey, I have a
Got a
question
giant
for
bag
you.
of fucking cheese.
I have a
I'm sorry,
question
you were
for you.
talking?
Yeah, I was talking. Thanks for cutting me off.
Well, I'm listening.
God.
Just
Man,
edit.
Frasier is such a cool show.
Frasier,
Frasier's
Frasier,
cool.
Frasier. Yeah, the dad died recently, didn't he?
Oh,
What
damn, I didn't
the
know
hell?
that.
Why do you have to go right for that,
I mean,
man?
that's topical.
How did he die?
He's old.
Was he murdered? I don't know.
I mean, he
No,
is old.
he was John Mahoney. Is that his name? I think it is.
Yes.
Oh, we're about to
That
Wikipedia this
makes
shit.
sense. That sounds accurate. What you're saying?
He looks like a John Mahoney.
All right, so here's the deal. Here's my question. I'm gonna lay it on both of you. All right.
Gentle.
It's just a question I thought of. I've really been thinking about asking, and I was like, you know, it's the whole reason I wanted to do a graveyard again was for this one question.
Boy, you're really hyping this up. I
It's
hope it's
gonna be
good.
good, trust me. It's
You
gonna live
gotta
up.
stick the landing here,
It's gonna
man.
live up to the graveyard standards, whatever those are. So, Jenga, we'll start with you. If you were a vegetable, which one would you be?
I got
Oh man,
this.
that
You go
takes
first,
me right back to like 2 years ago.
Jenga.
This sounds appropriate. Fuck. Vegetable, you say?
Yep.
Is this a culinary vegetable or like a plant species vegetable? Because a tomato is a fruit, but it's a culinary vegetable.
I'm gonna have to go with the salad.
Had a feeling that was coming.
Come
I had a
on,
feeling that
man.
was in the bullet chamber.
If I wasn't gonna fucking do it now, I was gonna forget. Yeah, that's my answer.
What'd you
Do it.
choose?
I chose the fucking salad.
No, it's okay. A salad is not a single vegetable here. All right. We've well established that you like salad. I understand. I think at one point you said you would, you we were talking about like hamburger, favorite fast food things. And you're like, I'm a man that likes just, you know, salad is nice. You better be decking those salads out with like chicken and like the works and stuff. These better not just
I'm
be
not.
like iceberg lettuce with some fucking ranch on it.
It's just a couple croutons, man.
Oh, God damn it.
I do like the iceberg lettuce with some fucking ranch and tomatoes on it. The whole wedge salad is tight. It's all crunchy and shit.
Crunchy.
Oh, so yeah, so you chose a salad, so
Yep, going
nice.
the
It's a, do you grow salads in your garden by chance?
salad.
Temp, what do you got? What's your vegetable? What
Totally
vegetable are
gotta
you
make
gonna be?
distinctions. Are we talking culinary vegetables or actual like science
What
vegetables?
does that mean? What are the
Whatever you
fuck you
want.
using
All
those
right,
big
let's not
words
get
for?
yeah, I don't want this to get technical. Just do your thing, all right?
It's $10 words or
Let's just
less.
move
Sadly
on.
a
No, let's
fruit, but
just
it's a
move
culinary.
on.
All right, fine,
We're
cool.
moving on. No, I'm just
No, I want
kidding.
to hear his
What
vegetable. What is
vegetable?
it?
What
Is it
vegetable are you?
enchilada?
I'm gonna say eggplant.
Well, I
It's technically
somebody.
not a
You know, I thought
vegetable, but
you
it
would
mixes with
be. Yeah,
vegetables.
I thought you would be
Yeah.
eggplant.
I like the color,
The
and
Thanos
I feel like
penis.
it's chill.
But it's chill.
It's, it is.
Do you
Doesn't bother
meditate? Do
anybody.
you meditate?
I don't. I should.
Yeah, you need to get on that. Live up to your zen ways.
Don't feel like there's much of a contest. Like, you can't replace meat with carrots, but you can replace meat with fucking like eggplant parmesan. I think that's tight.
All right. All right. New question. New question.
All right.
And if I were to choose the vegetable, by the way, my antsy, God damn it. Let's just take it from the top. Just take it from the top. Welcome
What's
to the
more of a
graveyard
feeling?
shift. I have a question for everyone. No, Terry Schiavo.
Who?
Oh, that's fucked up.
Wasn't she
like... not at all time relevant?
I know, I missed it by like 10 years. Just kidding. That's not a laughing matter. That's unfortunate.
I don't know what the fuck you're talking about.
I don't know. Temp inappropriately laughed at that joke. That was right. Meant for like...
meant for 2003.
Yeah, I missed that one. Sorry.
I still can't believe you guys are laughing about John Mahoney over there. You guys are a legend.
Nobody's laughed. No one laughed about that. That's
a... No one gives a fucking shit about fucking... What's his name on that show?
John Mahoney?
What's his name on the show? What's his character?
It's like Ranger's dad. Yeah,
his name. What is his name?
I don't know his name.
Martin. Martin Crane. God.
No. Come on.
Fucking.
Get it together.
Godless heathens.
Okay, fine. We'll move on to the next question. Oh, wait. Yeah, thank the vegetable you. I was going to be. You know, vegetables. Cucumber. Yeah, let's go cucumber. Yep. Because then I can.
Really?
I want to be pickled. No, actually, I want to be a habanero. I love habaneros.
Yeah, habaneros, if you're a pickled cucumber, you're just a pickle.
Yeah, I want to be a habanero, though. We've moved on, okay?
All right, well, listen, I'm glad that we didn't do fucking one cucumber and one eggplant. Like,
it's
a little quick for all these dicks, man.
That's a DP. That's dangerous. We're talking V to A rip there. That's not.
I'll just stick with the salad.
That's taking two and make it into one. All right. Anyways, next question here is.
How many of these you got?
I don't have any. I found a couple questions that I thought I thought people would want to know. You know.
You ought to know.
Is that like a...
Alanis Morissette
reference?
I'm just trying
O'Connor.
To stay as topical
nice.
As you guys are, man.
Sinead O'Connor, the lead singer of the Cranberries, recently passed away, and you got to make a joke about it.
Dude, listen, that's
not
cool.
An accurate statement, sir.
One of those
she didn't pass away?
Not dead.
No, Sinhead is very much alive.
Did you call her Skinhead?
No, Sinhead. It's Sinead, but... As a kid, I pronounced it Sinhead O'Connor.
Oh, you're on like a...
I see what you did.
You're on like a first name base, like a first name basis with her, right?
Man, Sinead O'Connor got fucking old, but she's super not dead. The Cranberries lead singer, I don't remember her actual name, but she did pass.
But she is super not old, but she is super dead.
Yeah, she was like 40s. That was sad. I grew up with Cranberries. I grew up with
And fucking Sinead O'Connor doesn't seem like fun to hang out with. She seems kind of like serious.
She seems intense.
She's got lots of opinions and feelings. She burned shit on the Saturday Night Live, man.
Yeah, she ripped up a picture of the Pope.
That's like, it's like, dude, chill. Just chill a little bit.
At least tell Lorne Michaels before you do it. Like.
All right, I have a question.
All right, okay.
Okay, we'll start with Temp this time. If you were in a circus, what would your job be?
Ooh.
What would your preferred job be in that circus?
All right. I like juggler. I think juggler's good.
Can you juggle?
No.
Well, that would be a horrible job for you then, wouldn't it?
It's better than tightrope, because even if I could tightrope, I don't want a tightrope.
You better be funny, dude.
Why don't you juggle on the tightrope?
That sounds really high risk, and that sounds like a liability. I feel like I could Google juggling and like practice. Like, I figured if I can learn guitar and bass, juggling is only the next step.
Wait, hold on. Back up for a second. How is that, like, next up in line? Like, there's a flow chart here, and I don't feel like you flow from guitar to juggling.
I mean, you just start with one chainsaw, and you just keep adding them. You just muscle memory, bro.
I don't think that answered the question, but...
Right. Just keep that net. Don't go flying Grayson on the first night, man.
I don't know why there can't always be a net. Like, I don't know why the lack of a net makes it. Like, it's like, does the audience want him to fall? I don't get it. Doesn't make
sense. Yeah, that's the whole point. Like, fucking, it's sick. These guys could totally, this family could die. It's amazing.
It's still impressive if there's a net. It doesn't stop being impressive if he's juggling chainsaws while tightroping over a net. Like, it still takes a lot of skill.
Sure, but without the net, it's like, you know, it's like Russian roulette. With
what I'm saying. Exactly. I agree with you.
I would want to be the bear that's on the bicycle. I have fantasies about that.
I would want to be the bicycle.
Did we just like did we just become best friends right there? I'll be the bear, you be the bicycle. I'll wear a nice like birthday hat and we'll make this happen.
$1 million.
You better have a squeaky horn. I want the full thing. I went, "Hong."
Can you wait, is it less cool if you have training wheels?
Do you have a basket? I just want to know. Do you have a basket? Don't ask why.
I can get a basket.
Will you have like pegs on the wheels? Is this like a tricked out bike, or is this like
one
of?
Do you need pegs?
I would prefer if you were one of those old timey bikes with a giant front wheel and a very tiny back wheel.
Do you need some like extra support?
Yes, and I also need a top hat and a fake mustache.
I don't have those.
The monocle is optional.
I'm just bicycles. I'm not wearing.
You're multiple bicycles. What the hell? Yep. This one isn't good enough for you.
Listen, I never said I was gonna like do a monogamous thing here, man.
It can't be a two-wheeler, right? For me, I feel like it has to be either a unicycle or a tricycle. Because if you put a bear on a bicycle, it doesn't look like he's at the circus. It looks like he's on the way to work.
Dude, I'm just telling you, bears on bicycles are like one of the best things that exist.
I don't know. If it's on a tricycle, it's fucking weird.
I feel like that's like somebody waiting to get killed. I don't want to see a bear on bicycles.
Hold on there.
So he doesn't want to be late for something.
But I do want to make money, so.
All right, look in the general chat, because this is what's happening right now. I want to be that bear, and you are going to be that bicycle, sir.
I like that sick-ass blue wheel. Yeah, it's rocking
okay.
out.
It's good.
That's some sick. We get some sponsorship?
We're styling.
For safety.
Now, if we could somehow manage this size, like if you want to be a tiny bike, then we could do something like this. I kind of like this. I would destroy you.
Oh, for that, dude, you got to give me some time to get down to that weight.
What is with the giant rabbit? What is with the giant rabbit in the back little fucking cart?
I think it's just a rabbit head. I don't think there's enough room for a full rabbit in there.
No.
Oh, I thought it was a weird mushroom.
Damn.
All right.
He's like bringing his fucking, you know, recreational shit with him.
Okay, so you're the bike. All right, so that question has been answered here.
Uh-huh.
I have one last one here.
Oh, all right.
If you, Django, had an invisible imaginary friend, what would his or her name be?
Invisible and imaginary, you say?
Yes.
So it can't just be one or the other?
Both. It's got to be both.
Oh, man, this makes it hard. Tad.
Did you say, hold on, Tad?
No, wait.
You could not have chose like a lamer name, Tad.
I got it. Tedrick.
Hold on, Tad. I can't let go of Tad here. Tad? Tad is like, wasn't that Little Giants where one of the kids' name was Tad?
Was it?
I don't know.
I never played Little Giants.
It's not a game, it's a movie. Oh. It's a movie with the guy from Honey, I Shrunk the Kids and Ghostbusters.
Well, look, dude, listen.
It also has the guy from, it's Ed O'Neill from Married with Children.
Rick Moranis, Ed O'Neill. That's actually a pretty good children's movie.
Yeah.
I haven't revisited it in like over like 15 years, but at the time I liked it a lot.
It was good. I've seen it several times. It's a usual Saturday night watch.
It's on rotation?
Yeah, it's in the rotation.
All right, it's not bad. All right.
So Tad, and then you change Tad to...
No. His name is Tedrick. Sometimes we shorten it to Tad, but it's Tedrick.
Okay, now you're losing me. So you shorten Tedrick, which is not a real name. You just made that up right now. Tedrick, okay. And you shorten to Tad. Wouldn't you shorten it to Ted?
No, because we already have a friend named Ted. I don't want the confusion.
That is actually a legitimate response. That makes sense.
Yep.
Good. Temp.
I'm trying to pull the wool over your eyes here, man.
What's your imaginary friend's name?
This is actually hard, because all the other questions, despite how silly and crazy the answers were, those were real answers. Like, I do, like, I would juggle if I was in the circus. I would be my number one choice. I would be an eggplant if I was a vegetable. I do think the eggplant. I do relate to the eggplant. I've never had an imaginary friend. I don't know if I don't have a point of reference.
I've never had one. Is you make it sound like that's like a normal everyday thing. You know, believe it or not, I've never had an imaginary friend.
I wasn't part of the imaginary friend school of thought. I don't know.
My family was poor. We couldn't afford imaginary friends.
Like, if I'm imagining my imaginary friends say, Temp, what is my name? It's all existential and shit. I would first of all ask him, well, what do you want to be called? And I imagine him saying, fucking, such a weird-ass question. Let's call him Bartholomew.
Yeah, I'm disappointed in that.
Yeah.
At least Tedric to Tad made sense. You're Bartholomew?
Yeah, it feels arbitrary, but it is arbitrary. Like,
don't let him hear you say that. Come on. What a dick move. Jesus Christ. I don't think that you've ever had an imaginary friend.
Clearly, with Bartholomew.
You can take the roadblocks down. It's out there now.
Okay. Well, Cyborg, you asked the question, so I have to assume you have an answer ready.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm.
The answer.
Whenever you're ready.
The answer is Speedy McQuaxon.
Okay.
He's a duck.
I was going to ask, is he a fast duck?
Don't be ridiculous.
Or is it ironic?
Okay, first of all, don't insult him. And second of all, yeah, he may not really exist because he's imaginary, but he still has feelings, and you hurt every damn near one of them. So
that's fine.
No, I'd rather we just move on. You know,
do you ever call him like Mother Ducker for short, even though it's long?
I'd prefer we just move on.
Do you like duck? Have you eaten much duck?
Duck is good.
I
had some duck at a Chinese restaurant. It was sick.
I don't need to answer that, and I want to move on.
All right, well.
I do not consent to this conversation any longer. Just because I consented at the start does not mean I consent now. So let's move on, sir. Otherwise, I will be pressing charges.
You know, when you said now, it kind of sounded like a duck.
And when you said McQuack.
Yeah, well, Bartholomew's a fucking stupid name.
Yeah, it is. At least Speedy McQuaxon.
Speedy McQuaxon would take him out in a heartbeat. He'd cut his throat.
When someone asked me to fucking picture an imaginary friend, I just picture a disembodied mass with eyes. I don't have any associations with it at all. It just kind of sort of.
Why does he have eyes? That's fucking weird.
It's just what I picture in my brain. It's just. How do you picture something that doesn't exist?
Why does he need eyes? If he doesn't have the rest of his body, why are you like, wait, he's got to have eyes?
Temp, my name is Tachilla, and you are pissing me off right now. You challenge Wakanda, and I don't like it.
It sounds racist.
I don't want to challenge Wakanda. I'd lose, like, hard. I get bodied.
What do you want to challenge?
I can't use a staff or weapons. I can't use anything.
Are you
Wakanda
done?
Wakanda sucks.
I'm done.
Whoa, okay. All right.
Yep.
You thought Black Panther was the worst Marvel movie, didn't you?
No, I liked it. I thought it was good.
The worst superhero movie ever.
I agree.
No, it was fine.
It was okay.
It was alright.
It
wasn't a revelation.
Yeah, that's kind of the thing. Like, I don't really have super strong feelings about it. I thought it was a solid movie. I'm glad I went.
There's like one or two things that I really didn't like about it.
But... What? Let me guess one of them. If it would have taken place in Greenwich, Connecticut, you would have liked it better, huh?
You know, can we blow up a school in Connecticut? That would be cool. I would like that. Because that's actually something that happens in the comics, and it's fun. Fucking Wanda, stealing everybody's stories in Civil War.
You leave her alone.
Listen, man, it's not me she's got to worry about. It's those weird collars that the movies have that only work on mutants, but they don't have mutants in the MCU. Where'd that collar come from?
They will soon enough.
It's been... I mean,
there's really no reason why they wouldn't mention them now. I mean, they practically own everything.
Well, not yet.
It's a done deal. It's just it's semantics at this point.
It's not. It's not a done deal
it's
yet.
It's a lot of ins. It's a lot of outs, but that's all.
If fucking, you know, if the third party comes in, it's like, listen, man, you can't buy it. Somebody else is going to buy it. It's going to be fucking weird. Whenever you try to buy anything for a bajillion dollars, somebody has to come in and referee. And that's the government.
All right, let's pull Ishii in here.
So it's like an escrow type situation, maybe?
Hey, Ishii, what's going on? What do you got for us?
Do you represent escrow?
Hey, what's up, Ishii? You got anything for us?
We might have to unmute him.
There we go.
I feel like he put him on the spot.
He put in the purple penis.
Oh.
I should probably clarify where he put them.
What does that mean? I'm not familiar with this. I don't know what you're talking about. Can you elaborate? You don't have to, though.
It's in the chat. It's in the one of the text channels. Questions or message to come on the show as the one above hosts.
What are you saying right now?
What does that have to do with the...
Yeah, I don't know.
Eggplant.
Temp, try and stay on topic, please.
I like eggplant.
You know, I've never had eggplant. I don't
it's good. I think it's solid. I would get eggplant parmesan. I think it'll...
I would like to like eggplant, but no one will tell me what it means. I keep asking.
All right. Ishii wants me to put him back in.
All right,
let me get him back in here.
Just I don't remember what we're talking about.
Make some room. Yeah, there we are. All right. You are back in, and how's that feel? Ishii? Ishii, are you in yet?
You shouldn't have to ask.
Ishii, are you in?
And you got to unmute him, dude.
I'm not on... Do I got a show? There he is.
Oh, Jesus Christ.
You just literally brought me in without warning, and my mic fell, and I was
okay,
like screaming.
Okay, let's throw it on me then!
We did.
That was the plan.
What's up?
Okay, excuse me? Nothing much. What are you guys doing?
We're not up to anything. What's up? We're just recording a show. Are you dragging your mic across like the table?
No, I'm trying to screw it back on because it
excuse me, off. We're not gonna have that potty mouth in here, sir. We're gonna try this one more time. Hey Ishii, how's it going?
It's going. How about you, man?
How's your day?
Two more times.
Well,
I can only handle one at a time.
Well, I mean so funny thing is, I actually did not go to work today because my dumbass forgot my fucking vest. And I was like, and I already got in the parking spot, and I'm like, oh shit, what do I do now?
Temp, so I was like, what should he do, Temp?
What should I?
They don't have spare vests at work. They don't have an extra blue vest to rock out.
Fucking Walmart, dude.
See, Temp gives great advice. He can help you out here. What should he do?
Oh, it's Walmart. I didn't know it was Walmart. It was Walmart,
yeah, dude. Yeah, they don't have spare. They don't have spare vests. Best at Walmart.
Oh yeah, you can buy that shit off eBay. You just buy yourself it's a great thing on Black Friday. You just buy one of the vests, you just go right inside, take what you want. Works like a charm.
It actually does work. You can just go in and ask someone for theirs that's wearing one. They'll just, you know, okay, here you go. They might brighten their day actually. Oh, my poor aunt. She hates it.
Why don't we laugh at that? I'm sorry.
It's okay, man.
He laughed first. He broke that ice.
I'm a horrible piece of shit. You should really just blame it on me.
Hey,
I don't think you're a horrible piece of
Walmart
shit.
Walmart is based here in my lovely home state. I always forget about it until someone starts talking about Walmart.
The home state of Russia.
Oh yes, it's the best state there is. Best state in the Union. Do you know about that?
Duh.
Fucking Russia, United States of America.
Duh.
Suka bilet.
Our national bird, state bird, our national state bird is duh.
It's called Privet.
What are you saying? Kotovash papa.
Yeah.
Kotovash papa.
Remember that one guy? That was fucking a pig.
Da.
He was fucking a pig at Walmart.
Pantalones. In fuego.
Listen, we had it. We were discussing something. Okay.
Ishii, I have something to break to you. Jingo wants me to basically ride him like a bear would ride a bicycle. What are your thoughts on that?
I would love to see that. Record it, send it to me. DM it to me.
Oh my God, you know, actually, we might have something here.
I don't know. That would have to. He needs further review.
I mean, there's a lot of ins, lots of outs.
It's okay. Just draw it out, blueprint it, and send it to me.
I don't think anyone would not want to see that. If someone like human could emulate the function and qualities of a bicycle. If Why you would will, not want to see that?
Fine. If you don't do it, I'll draw it, bitch. I'll go there. I'll draw it.
I want to see what Django looks like as a bicycle.
What wouldn't be the first time I drew you guys? I'll do it again.
Excuse me?
I have never been drawn in my life. Thank you.
I remember that my very first Nethercast fan art was like fucking Razor in Jedi robes, and he was being like fucking attacked by cats, and like his only defense was a lightsaber.
That's based on a true story.
Yeah, that's it was based off of my favorite graveyard episode.
Does he hate cats?
He hates babies, actually.
He hates babies, not cats.
Oh, I didn't know about babies either.
If you go back to the graveyard shift where we did the either or, I think the question was, would you rather, if you had to choose, to his credit, I mean, this wasn't something you just threw out there.
Is this like my cousin fucker situation?
He totally threw it out there.
No, like the question
was either he has to kill a baby or he has to kill like 10,000. Yeah, it was like 100 puppies or something. Like he chose the baby. I mean, what a sick fuck.
I mean, if you know, if popular movies are anything to go by, that is worse. Killing the puppies is way worse than killing babies. Babies die all the time. I think Wanda in Civil War killed some babies.
I mean,
it was totally cool. There's no dogs in that building.
How do you
promise?
How do you measure a baby's life versus puppies' lives? Like, how many puppies do you think equals a baby?
At least 50.
All right.
We just covered this.
Okay then. All right.
I mean, come on. This is basic mathematics here. It is known.
It is known.
It is known.
All right. Well, thanks for tuning in, Ishii. No one else has said they wanted to come on, so I don't want to just randomly pull people on because I feel like that'd be rude. So
is that what you did?
Totally asked for it.
Yes, I kind of did. And I'm really struggling to hold my mic on right now. It's literally about to fucking fall. And I'm holding it on with one hand. My mic stand it's loosened up. I don't know why.
Unroll a sock over it like Shadaloo does for his. he puts it up against the mic and just unrolls it right over. Sometimes he uses his mouth. I don't know.
I mean, that last.
That's actually.
I'd like to see that.
I think that's impossible, actually, because we have the same mic and they're huge. So that'd be talent. That'd be very talented if he could do that.
You got a snowball? I got a snowball.
It's a Yeti, actually.
You guys use the snowball? Oh, you use the Yeti?
It's a Yeti.
Alright, that's cool.
It's a Yeti.
A snowball Yeti. That would actually be painful. He'd have to unhinge his jaw like a snake to make that happen. I know, it sounds incredibly erotic, trust me.
I know. No.
You can make some money off that.
Not for me. Gross. That's like that. Hey, listen, man. We all need cam show money here and there.
Wait, hold on. Are you admitting to that? Because that's been a long-standing theory in the Nethercast community.
Yep. First came bicycles, then came Yetis.
And there was that one bit about cousin fucking.
Cousin fucking, we all know about that shit.
That's confirmed.
I don't think you actually have to do cam work to need the money, though. Everyone needs cam work money, but
I
not
didn't actually
does
have
work.
To be a cousin fucker.
It's not just money in general. It's cam money. It has to come from that.
It comes from the can, not the fucking.
Please.
It's not like you said a can, like spam or something.
I did actually say a can.
Yeah, I heard can. I got super confused, but okay, that makes sense.
See, that's the quality this Discord shit brings, man. Shit sounds good. You can
it's
hear it when
clear.
I fuck up and say can. Listen, Ishii. Yo. We were wondering, where the fuck did Wanda's mutant collar container thing come from in Civil War when there's no other mutants on the entire planet? Where'd that tech come from?
You got 3 seconds.
I'm sorry,
you're out of time. Thanks for playing, man.
I didn't watch Civil War.
Oh, jeez. Oh, snap. Oh, boy. We got a problem here.
You know, you don't actually have to watch it because I just told you exactly what happened.
You just spoiled it. That was the whole plot of the movie. Like, that was the entire thing right there.
It was everybody in that Civil War movie. Everybody from fucking Thor to Vision was trying to get that collar on Wanda. They took the whole movie to get it, and they finally got it.
Yeah, that was
they
the
finally
whole thing.
Got it.
He just
fucking
spoiled,
General Ross.
He just spoiled from, a movie that didn't happen.
From Incredible Hulk, he came back at the last at the fast 5 seconds with that collar, just running.
That's
and he lost weight. You saw weight falling off of him. He was thin in Civil War.
No, it was just dropping off of him. Like, I think he lost a leg at one point.
And Wanda was just about to say, no more mutants, boom, collar.
Let she was all out. Like, they tried to get me to put me in a collar, and I said, no, no, no.
Yeah.
Why is she, like, fucking, like a southern farmer at this point? Where does that voice
That's
come from?
That's always what she's been. She couldn't
That'd
be a
hilarious.
Mutant. She couldn't be a mutant due to copyright reasons, so they went with the next best thing.
Which is?
A southern farmer. Of course.
Interesting.
I know that's always been my thinking of it. I'm like, man, I'm already southern. All I have to do is learn how to farm and I can be on the X-Men.
Do you like chicken?
What if Sonya had a southern accent?
I wish she had something that was interesting.
yeah, all right. She's cool and stuff.
Just something to give her some character of some
kind.
You
know, chicken is a great segue because I have to take chicken out of my oven and chop that shit up. I'll be back in 10 minutes. But before I do that, I do have a quick PSA. This is actually serious.
A quick pee?
If anyone's curious, I'm actually doing the 100-day trial for that purple mattress thing. So for Rizzles, if anyone has questions about that and how that's going, hit me up on the Discord. I'll be
this
happy.
This is
to
a paid advertisement, I guess.
Questions. Oh, I'm chilling like fuck right now. Yeah, I'll be back in 10 minutes. Y'all have so much fun.
And when he says he's taking chicken out of the oven and chopping it up, you know that's innuendo for something. I don't know what it is personally, but I would imagine it's quite dirty.
Hey, listen.
I'm listening. Between
us, is that purple mattress shit like the
hey,
purple
listen.
Eggplant?
Purple.
I don't know what that means.
Yeah.
There's a lot of purple that you guys are talking about these days, and I'm feeling out of the loop.
Isn't purple your favorite color?
No.
Red.
No.
Blue.
No, that's you.
Mine's purple, blue, and green, actually, but I'm getting closer, aren't I?
You greedy bitch.
Okay, I like cool colors. I like all the cool colors. I don't like warm colors. I like cool colors.
Well, you know what? I like being involved in the conversation and not being left out of funny inside jokes, so I fucking want to know what the fuck is up with the purple mattress.
Do I sound like I'm on the old time radio?
No, you sound like a sleepy Bane.
I like black and red.
When Gotham is ashes, you have my permission to die.
I kind of turned into the Riddler there at the end, Jim Carrey Riddler. I don't know where that came from. Well, it came
sexual
from a bad idea, actually.
Little white lies.
Stay away.
Whoa, Joker?
Yeah, what was...
Was that a Luke Skywalker I heard?
Oh. Batman.
That was one of the best parts of that movie. Every once in a while to be like,
oh,
fucking Joker is down in that hole.
Issues broken. You broke him.
I was hoping that's what's going to happen.
He does whenever this. Actually, we should, goes. Django, just don't say anything. Let's just see how long he laughs.
I'm done.
Man, that was not as long as I was hoping. And that is what she said. All right, we're done.
Listen.
No, I'm listening. Damn it. Okay, Navi, you need to calm down with your listen. Listen.
You
hey.
Can all hey. Be the Joker.
Hey, listen.
Now you see a guy like me.
No, oh, you're making Zelda jokes.
That was like Jared Leto doing a Heath Ledger impression. That's what that sounded like.
Did you just say Keith Ledger?
No, I didn't say Keith, all right?
You said Keith. I heard Keith.
Yeah, we'll fix it in post. It's Heath. It's okay, it's not Keith though. Keith is that Bruce doesn't Bruce exist.
Bruce. Yet.
What are you talking about right now?
I think the fucking market is open for another Ledger. That's what I think. Fucking we all know that like Black Widow has Red in her Ledger. She should just sidestep, do lateral move, get in there.
Have you seen the movie Red Sparrow with Jennifer Lawrence?
No, because why?
Yeah, exactly. Let's
move
on.
Is it a Mystique movie where she's red now?
That would be cool. It looks like...
Wait, okay, what? I finally fixed my mic stand.
Okay, yeah, all right. Well, I'm glad you got it fixed, but, you know, it's getting a little late, you know. I'm just kidding. Yeah, you're good.
Oh shit! What happened to me?
I've been wondering. I don't know.
I'm trying to fucking get my purple color in this game, and I can't. God damn it! I did it again.
See, you like purple. See, you admit it.
No, I like Donatello, and he wears purple. God damn it! But no, I don't have the purple shader because it's the only one that I have that says unlock through gameplay.
Are you playing Injustice right now?
I would never. And then I have to. He's wearing red. My Donatello is wearing red. It's a fucking disgrace.
Would you rather cross dimensions or cross time periods?
Wait, so it's would you rather be Doc and Marty or Rick and Morty? Is that what you're asking?
Pretty much, yeah.
The destination is kind of important.
Morty, I gotta have that Szechuan sauce, that sweet nectar. I did have that Szechuan sauce. It's decent.
Dimensions.
Yeah.
Or what was the other one? Time?
Time. Like, would you rather cross dimensions or cross time periods?
Don't remind him, all right? If he doesn't he doesn't deserve it.
If I'm crossing time periods, that's
I mean, it's the same universe. It's just different time periods.
That's not that interesting.
Okay, just shit all over what he's asking you, all right? Show a little respect.
But then Dimensions is like a fucking crapshoot, man. That's like a crazy-ass gamble.
Yeah, I would
choose
Dimensions.
What if my mom's not my mom and she tries to fucking hit on me in a different dimension? Because we know that wouldn't happen if fucking just switching time.
Or better yet, it's your cousin?
That already happened.
No, okay.
Would you stop bringing up the cousin thing? This is why we stopped doing the graveyard, because it was just... Once you go fucking your cousin, you just don't... It's everything becomes about fucking cousins, all right? Let's just move on from it.
Damn, okay. I didn't know you wanted...
It hurts, okay? You know, like, everyone was like, fuck you, Django. Temp was really just jumping down his throat. He was like, I judge you so hard. And I was defending him. I was like, hey, man, you know, back off and stuff. Like, pop off.
Temp was... Totally the one that named that episode and everything.
Okay, first of all, when we were recording, somebody had suggested that's what the name has to be. I think it was Razor.
That sounds... Mm-hmm.
You don't believe me, I can tell. But that's true, though. I mean, it's based on fact.
Listen, man, I believe that you believe.
What are you saying right now? I don't...
That I really wish I had this purple shader for Donatello. This is fucked up.
All right. That's all you had to say, dude. That's all you had to say. All right. Okay.
Listen, man.
See this issue? Look what you did. You're dividing us right now.
Is chicken.
Oh, chicken. Chicken does sound good. To the question. Oh, man. Chicago pizza. What's better? Chicago deep dish style pizza or New York style pizza?
I have not had Chicago style pizza. So
man, it's so good.
Have you had New York?
Of course I had New York pizza, yeah.
Oh.
What do you mean? Do you live in New York?
Yeah. Live in New York?
I've had New York style pizza before.
Maybe but why is that of course, New York, but not Chicago?
Did you have it in New York?
Well, I don't know.
Did you have it delivered?
Well,
let him answer one question first.
I got questions.
He's got questions.
Does it like have to be made in New York or just like the certain style of it?
You know, it depends on who you ask. And most people from New York will say, fuck yeah, it has to be from New York.
Well, fuck those Italians. I'm just kidding.
Well, you know. Yeah, I agree. I mean, listen, I've never had eight either, so I really have no idea.
Okay, all right.
So yeah, back to dimensions. Dimensions or time periods?
That's a tough one, you know?
I think it's dimensions, even though I don't like the question. It's just, I need more information. I really need more information.
Okay, so basically, you're crossing, like... Okay, this is going to be DC logic.
Dimensions, like, it's universes.
Not DC logic.
You're essentially going to basically alternate universes of yourself. So, like, things could be different. Or would you rather stay in this universe and go back in time or forward in time or whatever?
I hate DC logic.
All right, just answer the question. Okay, fine. You know, I use my nipples about it.
It can be any kind of dimension jumping you'd like.
Okay, but still, like, the important part is, like, what's going on over there? Am I just gambling? Is it like a box of chocolates? I never know what universe I'm going to get.
You can choose whatever dimension you want to go to.
I feel like you're really dragging this out, you know?
No, I'm not dragging either. I hate dragons. I don't know what's over there. Do they have dragons?
You love dragons. Sub-Zero rode one, and you're all like, I want to be that dragon more than I want to be that bicycle. Well,
there might be a dimension where you are the dragon.
See, I don't like that might word in there. I'm trying to just figure out, like, weigh my odds here, and it doesn't sound like they're very good.
All right, fine. While you figure that out, I got a question for Ishii.
I fucking hate boxes of chocolates.
Ishii.
Yes.
And Forrest Gump.
I got a scenario I'm going to lay down on you, okay?
Sure.
So I dropped into my friend's house to give her a birthday cake I spent all day making, okay? You with me so far?
Mm-hmm. B&E?
And I saw my best friends having an orgy that day. See, I was sad because I was apparently the only one not invited. How would you feel in that? Pretty sad, right? Okay, so I'm justified.
So it wasn't just two people.
They said I could join in if I wanted. I mean, this is kind of a delayed invite if you ask me. They're only inviting me because I was there and it became awkward. It
sounds like
but you could tell no one really wanted me to join. So I left them the cake and went to the cinema by myself instead. So I guess my question to you is, in this whole scenario, which person in this whole orgy disaster would you rather be? My best friends, the person who made the cake, or the cake? I mean...
Wait, did you say that you went to Cinnabon?
I feel like if something like that would have happened to me, I would have taken it very personally, being me. Like, I feel like there was some sort of, you know, like, reasoning why I wasn't invited to the orgy, so I guess I'd be the person in the orgy.
So you want to be the best friends?
I'd rather be the dick than the victim.
You don't want to be the guy that made the cake or the cake. You just want to be the friends that are fucking while I am going there and not invited. All right.
Listen, okay. Though.
Well, why didn't you invite me? I want to know.
There's questions. Like, maybe they know of a reason that you wouldn't want to be invited to such a thing. They'd be considerate.
Okay, so you're saying there's like another level to this. It's like a layer in this whole
obviously.
Cake. It's like a cake with layers. I love layered cake.
It's like, you know, listen, they know... that you are not into orgies. It's just overwhelming. So,
I mean, I feel like there's some assumptions being made.
They care about your feelings, and they're being considerate.
All right. Okay, well then I have one for you, Django. I'll run a scenario by you.
I love scenarios.
Since you got you know all the answers. You're the Riddler, you know.
I'm not. I'm the guy
you
that
are
asks
Jim,
questions.
You are
I
Jim
answer
Carrey.
With lots of questions.
That's okay.
He is a ginger, so it does work.
Okay.
I'm not a ginger. Who's a ginger?
You said you were a ginger in the graveyard, okay? We got you all figured out. I know you
I've never been a ginger in my life. not even once.
Sure.
It's
sure.
Like not drugs. Even not even once. Yeah, not even once. All right, I got you. You just ruined Smoke Man's day because he thought he could relate to you, but...
Okay, there's a little period in college. You're right.
Everyone experiments with gingers. I know. All right, I got it. Okay, so here's the scenario. This one's for you to answer. So I'll kind of lay out the story for you. So it was the first day of volleyball practice, all right? I was young. I was into volleyball for a little bit. It was a phase. So it's the first day of volleyball practice, and I ate an entire pot of mac and cheese. Love mac and cheese. I ate the whole damn pot, all right? We were running laps outside, and all of a sudden I had to take a shit. It's not good. It's that mac and cheese shit. You know what I'm talking about. So the school is closed, so I moved. Do not interrupt until I'm done, okay? The school was closed.
When you're done,
so I moved to the woods, as anybody would, as quickly as my clenched asshole would let me. But Jesus. There was nothing that could stop the watery mess that was exploding from my asshole. I was forced to sit in my own messy shit. It gets worse, trust me.
Much worse than the not messy shit.
My mother had to come pick me up, knowing that standing up would cause the shit to just slide down my legs. God, it's embarrassing. I opted for a crab walk across the field to the car. Oh, God. Everyone knew why. Everyone knew. I tried to hide it with the crab walk, but people knew. So I guess really what I'm asking you is, which shitty person would you rather be? Me, the one who just shit themselves, my mother, who clearly knew what was going on, or the car seat?
So were you eating the macaroni and cheese while you were playing volleyball?
You know, you're getting personal. Were you
eating the macaroni and cheese while you were running?
I ate it before I started. And then when I was running laps, that's when I started to shit, okay? I had to go. So I mean, which one would you rather be in that scenario? Me shitting myself, doing the crab walk, trying to hide it from everyone. My mother, who clearly was trying to bail me out of this but knew what was going on. Or, God forbid, the car seat that I had to sit on the way home.
I mean,
if you want to be the car seat, I understand, dude.
I feel like I'm right back in the cousin fucker scenario again. There's only
one obvious answer to this, and you know who.
Yeah, it's, I gotta go with fucking my cousin.
No, I'm talking about...
Oh.
You really doubled down on that one.
You know? Can I be the volleyball?
No, that's not an option.
Man, dude. Okay, listen. You're right. I'll go with what you did.
What? Which one?
I'll make the same call you did.
That
I trust your judgment.
You would want to be me in that scenario.
I think you're a smart guy. I think that you chose well.
All right.
You chose wisely.
You did. I mean,
thank you.
First, you chose terribly, but after that, you chose all right.
Thank you.
Yeah. Con approved.
I appreciate that.
So did you like?
Are you gonna answer Ishii's question now? Because I've given you plenty of time to think about it.
What was the what?
It's okay. You don't have to answer it if you don't want to.
I don't remember what it was.
It was.
Was it the one about
the dimension jumping?
DC universe being whitewashed.
Yeah.
Okay. Yeah, I'm going to answer that one in the affirmative.
Sounds good.
DC's great.
And back.
All right, Tim, I have a question for you. Okay? I'm going to lay a scenario down for you.
Do it.
Django struggled to answer it. Django, I don't want to hear anything. He struggled to answer it. He started wanting to fuck cousins again. I don't know where he came from, but I just need you to answer this question. Okay?
Okay.
You with me so far? Do you think so you're up to the challenge?
You got to go fast.
No, I don't. But I'm going to try anyway.
I don't think... You know, you just don't sound on...
Not feeling super confident.
Okay, fine. All right. Here's the deal. It's a situation that I was in.
You got to go fast.
It's based on facts. It's a real situation I was in. And I just want your opinion and where you stand, whether you stand with me or whatever. Okay? So here's the deal. It was volleyball practice. This is when I was in middle school, all right?
Okay.
I didn't know that detail. That's important.
You didn't pay attention to the details, all right?
You never said nothing about middle
It was the first day of
school.
Volleyball practice. I just tried it out. It was like intramural or whatever you call those.
This
so,
shit is rigged.
It was the first day of volleyball practice. And before I even started playing, because with most sports, obviously, you got to do some laps and do that kind of stuff to warm up. So I made the mistake of eating an entire pot of mac and cheese. I mean, do you blame
Sounds
me?
Good.
Yeah, no. No, not at all. I mean, probably not the best timing right before volleyball practice, but it was my first day. I didn't know what to expect, okay?
See, so, he's telling the story Django, way better
no.
this time.
Okay, see, you're interrupting is what you're doing, sir. This is for Tim
to decide.
Last
time, I was convinced he had a pot of macaroni and cheese in his arm and was playing
No. All right, so are you with me? First day of volleyball practice. I ate an entire pot of mac and cheese. Okay. So we were running laps outside, and all of a sudden, I had that feeling, that grumbling feeling in my stomach. I had to shit. Okay? I shouldn't have eaten the mac and cheese before volleyball practice. Okay? So, unfortunately, it was later in the day, and the school was closed. So, right by the school, there's some woods, so I moved to the woods as quickly as my clenched ass cheeks would let me, all right? You can only run so fast while you're trying to keep that thing closed. You with me so far?
Yeah.
Okay.
Picture you doing the Jason.
Unfortunately, there was nothing that I could do to stop the watery mess that was exploding from my asshole from coming out.
Oh, I hate that part.
Okay, so I was forced to sit in my own messy shit, okay?
I like how he specifies messy at this part.
Yes. So
it's not just normal shit.
It's unfortunate, but to bail me out of the situation, because I couldn't go back to volleyball practice and I needed to clean myself up. So my mom had to come pick me up, knowing that standing up would cause the shit to slide down my legs in this scenario. I opted for a crab walk across the field to her car.
Were you wearing shorts?
Everyone knew what I was doing and knew exactly why I was crab walking across the field to her car. They knew I had to shit my pants, and it was happening at that very moment. So
yeah, you weren't just
bringing
being awesome like the normal people doing the crab walk across the field. They knew what was up.
Are you done? Bringing us back to the beginning.
Boy.
Which shitty person would you rather be in this situation? Me, the shitter. My mother, who had to bail me out. Oh, God. The car seat.
Such a long story.
Like, this is easy. I'd rather be the Good Samaritan mother. I don't think that's a hard question.
That's exactly what I said. Like, there's only one obvious answer in this scenario.
Well, you agree with 86% out there, okay? Good job.
Who wants to be the fucking car seat?
Apparently 8%, okay? 22,500 people voted for it.
But, you know...
You know that 8% is really into, like, Cleveland Steamers on their chests and all that.
Right, that's what I was gonna say. Like, those figures sound very accurate to, like, you know, how many people would actually be in a group of 100 that are into, you know, scat shit.
Excuse me?
I buy it. I get it.
Are you trying to make light of my situation?
Make light?
Did you just assume my gender?
Trying to make light of your situation?
What was going on?
Was your situation light?
Was it instant mac and cheese?
Tell me about the flow.
It was easy mac, and I think that's part of the problem.
It was easy mac.
Yeah, that's Dude, I learned how to make my own mac and cheese. I've never gone bad at six. Like, dude, like, homemade mac and cheese is so fucking tight. I'm the biggest fan. It's so good. Instant mac and cheese is just, like, revolting to me now.
Pineapple on pizza, where do you stand?
I love it. It's good.
Is it your favorite?
Nah, it's not my favorite. But it's solid high mid-tier.
But you think it's acceptable, don't you?
Oh, yeah, of course.
Yeah, I thought you would.
I'm the eggplant guy. Of course I like pineapple on pizza. It makes perfect sense.
Yeah. All right, we're done here.
What do you think about pineapple on pizza?
It's all right. I used to have it when I was younger, and it was okay because my dad liked it, but then, like, I wouldn't ever get it myself, no.
Here's my problem with pineapple on pizza. It's fine in of itself, but people always want to pair it up with ham or Canadian bacon, which I think is the lowest fucking tier pizza topping. Like, the lowest fucking top, like, bottom.
That's fucking racist.
Just, that's how I feel, man. Canadian bacon's a bill.
Well, I mean, you know, you can't get much further away from Canada, I guess, than Texas.
Yeah, that's pretty far.
A United States citizen. I'm much better because I am, like, probably less than 100 miles to your north. So I am way, way, way better than you.
Yeah, you're a little further than that because I'm like,
Don't tell me where I'm at.
I mean, I'm like 500 miles from Dallas, so.
All right, yeah, I got a question for Ishii here. Okay.
Is it about pizza or shit?
No, neither. All right. Would you just let me tell the story? I'm gonna ask a question. Ishii, are you ready?
Go for it.
Okay. Suppose mom or dad has been telling you to do stuff all day, and you're fucking tired of it. All right. You want to say no. No, and I don't have to. And leave me alone.
Who's mom and dad?
Okay? You want to walk away and do what you want to do. What will you do, though? What will you do? Are you going to do those chores?
Jesus Christ.
Listen, man, I was born in a Persian family. You can't say no.
All right. All right, I got a question for Django, then, since he's a fucking brainiac over here, Mr. Interrupter. All right?
Are you going to answer my question?
You're playing with two good friends, Django.
No, I'm not. You guys are just okay.
All right.
We're mid-tier on your fucking friends list.
You're playing with two good friends and you know it. And you know what?
Maybe if your story was a little bit less about shit, you'd be a little higher.
This has nothing to do with shit. This has nothing to do with shit.
All right. Fucking come hit me. What do you got? What do you got?
There's a new kid.
Blow my mind.
There's a new kid at school who hardly talks and seems to look at the ground a lot. The other kids laugh at him, and they expect you to laugh with them. You know this child needs a friend, but if you become his friend, the other kids might not be your friends anymore. What will you do?
Okay, here's my questions.
Well, you know, it's better, because otherwise he might turn out to be the next school shooter. Okay, that's fine.
Damn.
Listen, man.
Okay, it's too soon. It's too soon.
Wait, it's
too soon for a long time. But I mean, it's 3 years.
So I won't delete this off the friggin'.
It's you know what? All right. I get it. Like,
all right, here we go. Temp, you're
here's
up.
The trouble.
Some of your friends have started drinking alcohol. Yeah, it's happening.
I was gonna
and they
the
seem
question.
To be having more fun than you. They've asked you to try it. What will you do?
I'm gonna try it because I like alcohol.
Wrong. Wrong. Ephesians 5:18, all right? 1 Corinthians 15:33. You do not try it, sir. You need to back off. All right.
Yeah, fucking Ishii. Galatians 6:12. Drink that shit.
Ishii, you are back up. You're at a friend's party, Ishii. You're at a friend's party, all right? At first, everything seems normal. Everything seems normal to you, but then you notice some people pouring something into their cups from a thermos. They're acting weird. Someone offers you a drink from said thermos. What will you do, Ishii?
I think he made the right move, man.
Wrong. And you want to know why you're wrong? 1 Corinthians 15:33. All right?
Okay.
All right, Django, you're up again.
Philippians 6:19. Make sure thermoses are clean. And if they're not, you're going to hell.
All right, Django, do you feel like you're ready for another one?
No. I thought I was.
You love the power you feel behind the wheel, and damn, it feels good. and you want to see what it feels like to drive fast. Oh man, that wind in your hair. You get your chance while driving alone in the car. The speed limit is 50. Mom is nowhere in sight. But there's no traffic on the road. What will you do?
Your mom or my mom? Because you said mom, so that would imply your mom.
You're not doing my mom, you motherfucker.
Listen, man, it makes a difference. That's an important question here.
See, you never answered the question. That's why I'm not going to ask you anymore. Temp, are you ready?
To be a fucking door so no one fucking comes in my room, I swear to God.
All right, Temp. You have a teacher or coach, it's up to you, who is always getting on you for no reason, and you're tired of it. You're not a kid anymore. You deserve respect. He is coming toward you. You can tell he's angry, and you know what's coming. Right now, you have to determine how you'll react. What will you do?
Listen, man, I feel like your question was pretty...
Romans 12:19. Wrong.
I hate choice. Driving. Your question was retarded. He couldn't have picked a worse question for me.
All right, you got one more chance. You got one more chance.
Anyone's mom.
Jingo, you have one more chance. Are you going to step up to the plate?
I don't know. Let me pray about it.
Okay.
Okay. Baseball.
Pretend you're playing with another child who is younger than you. That child has a toy and you want to play with it. You could just take the toy if you wanted to. You're bigger, you're stronger. You could switch it with the toy you have and he'll never know. The other child might cry, but maybe you won't get in trouble if you pretend you didn't do anything.
How much older is Django? Like, is Django like 25?
No one is looking now, Django. What are you going to do?
No one's looking.
No one's
and
looking.
He's got a sick ass toy.
He's got that sick ass toy.
Damn.
What are you gonna do?
Give me that shit. Get
wrong. Proverbs 3:3. All right.
Wait, so did 25-year-old Django just do a fire torch?
Let not steadfast love and faithfulness forsake you. Bind them around your neck. Write them on the tablet of your heart.
It kind of depends on the toy.
Mark 4:20.
Okay, we got
fucking eye for a toy.
Eye for a toy.
Listen, man. All right, Ishii. Fucking
okay,
Sunday Ishii. Church.
Ishii, you think you're like you know all the good things, all right? You're like Mr. Goody Two Shoes. Well, you know what? Some of your friends have started using bad language because it makes them feel cool. Yeah, real cool.
Oh yeah,
like a badass. It does. Each day you hear words you know your parents don't like. Your friends even use the names of God and Jesus as if they were just bad words. And they call you...
Christian.
And they... You need to shut the fuck up when I'm talking. Don't use that language, Ishii. Don't give in. And they call you a baby because you won't talk like them. What will you do?
They mean the things... With the amount of swear words I say, I don't think that's really too far off.
Wrong. Ephesians 4:29. Let no corrupting talk come out of your mouths. Both of them. Both of your mouths. But only such as is good for building up as fits the occasion, that it may give grace to those who hear. Now you
is
know.
Is that Ephesians?
Are you preaching to me? It sounds like you're preaching to me.
I think he's on a Bible website and he found Bible questions.
But wait a minute. Was it actually Ephesians?
All right.
What you said?
Was
it Ephesians?
Django, you need to back off. I got one for Temp here, okay?
Was it Ephesians? I didn't know if it was Ephesians.
I said Ephesians.
Because Ephesians don't have multiple mouths. They're not cows, like stomachs, dude. Ephesians had normal mouths.
I got one for Temp here, okay?
God, fucking racist against Ephesians all day. What's with you?
Ephesians like a fish, or I don't know what
Temp.
Fucking Ephesians are normal-ass people.
Temp, suppose you have one...
in Ephesia.
I need focus here.
I need Ephesian justice.
If you guys fail this last one, you've lost, all right? Temp is very relevant to you. Suppose you have one test question left to answer and time is running out. You've studied hard, you know the material, but you just can't bring that answer to mind. We've all been there. You need to shut the fuck up when I'm talking. You can copy your neighbor's answer without the teacher knowing. Besides,
now it sounds like Temp.
Besides, you know the answer is somewhere in your brain. So it only seems fair that you should get credit for it. What are you going to do?
You're going to stick that pencil in your brain and find it.
It's only one question, right?
It's one question left, my man.
Well, fuck it. I'm just going to turn in my paper. I got everything else right. I studied hard. I'm good.
Ooh.
Good job. Good job, sir. You finally got one right.
That was easy.
Oh, geez. You guys failed miserably.
Okay, yeah. Ask me another one.
All right. This is the last one. This is the last one.
All right. I have a question.
Ishii.
After this.
You're in the middle of an intense video game. Just a few more points and you'll beat your high score. You'll beat Billy Mitchell's score in Donkey Kong. Scores that they're not even legit. Allegedly. You hear Dad say it's time to turn off the game. The game's loud, so it would be easy to pretend you didn't hear him. That way, you could finish the game. What will you do?
Who says I don't do that already?
Wrong. Bad. Colossians 3:20. Children, obey your parents in everything, for this pleases the Lord.
I'll turn off the game. Fine.
Colossians?
You've already fucked it up. No, these aren't pickles, damn it. God.
You know what?
The good people of Kalasha were nice, dude.
You failed everyone, Django. I don't want to hear anything from you and your potty mouth.
I have a question.
What's up? Cool.
You're in a nuclear fallout by yourself and a chicken.
Oh, boy.
You have canned goods.
Okay.
You're now 2 weeks into the fallout.
Oh, shit.
And you're out of canned goods. You ran out of corn and green beans.
Okay.
You have a chicken.
Yes.
But your chicken looks sickly.
I've already thought about eating him. Yes. I don't even know the end of this. Okay.
It's oozing from the eyes. Its neck seems swollen.
All right, not bad. I'm still on board.
You don't have any cooking utensils. You have no way of cooking this thing. Do you eat the chicken?
Yeah, I'm not getting fucking salmonella and a sick dick at the same time. Fuck no. I'd rather starve or find something else at least.
I'm going to tear into his insides and eat it, yes. Do I like the chicken, though? Is he my friend?
You named it.
What's his name?
I didn't tear into his outside.
What's his name? This all depends on his name. What's his name?
Tedrick.
God damn it. Oh, jeez. I called him Tad for short. Oh, my gosh.
Your affectionate name was Tad.
Yeah, I'm a dead man. I'm not touching him.
I can't fucking believe you guys.
Django, what do you got for me? What do you got?
Yeah, Mr. So Judgmental.
I am flummoxed at this development.
You're flabbergasted?
Are you asking me to eat my imaginary friend?
No, it's real, but it's named after your imaginary friend.
Do I know the difference? Like, am I that hungry? Or am I fucking seeing crazy shit because I'm starving to death and there's nuclear bullshit everywhere?
It could be true, but the chicken's real. And the sickness is real.
Jesus Christ. Okay, was it my chicken or did I find it post-fallout?
No, you bought the chicken in preparation for a potential fallout. Trump pissed off Russia for rizzles. Or North Korea. Or some other country is mad at us right now. So you bought the chicken preparation, but you bonded. In the meantime, you became attached.
I don't bond.
Tedrick.
And I sure as hell wouldn't name it after my imaginary friend. That's fucked up.
New question. The fallout's coming.
I would eat the chicken, by the way.
Oh, man. Already? I feel like the last one came out just like 2 years ago.
All right.
Don't you mind.
All right, real talk. That was a warm-up question.
Okay.
You're in the fallout shelter.
Yep.
The fallout's happening, and you don't know how much longer before the radiation clears. The only things in the shelter are you and your dog. You run out of canned foods, and the dog looks sick. What do you do?
Now we've actually got questions here. I'm glad.
This reminds me of an Aqua Teen Hunger Force episode. I don't know why.
Well, I'm not going to fuck
you
it.
Go first.
Is that what you're asking? Fine, I'll do it, all right? You don't have to twist my arm about it.
The animal, are you going to consume its flesh for sustenance?
Absolutely not. It's a dog. I can't harm a dog.
I can't
eat
a dog.
If it was a baby, it would be fine.
Zatanna, get the fuck out of here. No one likes you.
What if the dog was completely healthy? Like, it was, like, purely, like, ready for the skinning, and you're super hungry. What do you do?
I'm not eating man's best friend.
Okay.
What's woman's best friend? Can I eat that?
You're gonna eat
What's
her
man's
money?
Second best friend? What's the man's side hoe?
It's cat, right? It's gotta be cat.
Do not fucking eat a cat. Jesus Christ. You will fucking That got real, really fast. Don't do
I always knew I was a woman.
Well, I'm glad we all have strong feelings about man's best friend here. I'm glad we found a consensus.
Yeah, and this is coming from a cat person, so yeah.
I'm a cat person myself, but I don't want to eat a dog or a sickly chicken that I named.
After my imaginary friend. Such a weird twist. It's like a Shyamalan movie.
I didn't want to pick your name either. I wanted to pick Cyborgs, but all I could remember was Duck. I couldn't remember the actual name.
Plotfish. That's why my name is Sick.
It was Speedy McQuaxton, and I would prefer he doesn't get brought up.
It was Speedy Bill Paxton, huh?
That'd be a sick name.
Bill Paxton passed away, and you're already going to mention his name that quickly? At least give it like 15 years before you mention his name.
It was game over, man.
Oh, damn.
Yeah, okay. You're real cute.
We got cows. That wasn't his line.
No, that was some Bernat chick's line.
She was kind of hot in that 90s sort of way. She had shoulder pads, though. I wasn't into that.
I don't mind short hair in women, but her hair was kind of puffy.
No, shoulder pads, dude.
Girl thing going on.
It was the shoulder pads. I can't do the shoulder pads.
What's wrong with shoulder pads?
They're weird. Why are they there? What are they doing?
Even Helen Hunt's kind of, I don't know. I think Helen Hunt's overrated.
Like what were the shoulder pads supposed to do?
Signify power and dominance.
Really?
I mean, that's how they seem to me.
I mean, it just looked like they're like kind of bony and shrugging all the time.
Are you trying to describe my sex life?
That's a question though, Cyborg. Which girl from Twister would you take home?
Mother Shrugger.
Girl from Twister.
Mm-hmm. You have about a Twister. Helen Hunt, random brunette, and Philip Seymour Hoffman. Go.
Easily.
No, there was the grandma. Don't you?
Oh shit! That's right.
Don't forget the grandma.
Food.
She got bodied by that tornado.
Food. Food.
But the dog was fine. You'll notice. Food. Babies died. The food. Dog was fine.
Food. Food. I think that should answer it. All right.
God, the guy's sick. I miss that dude.
Yeah.
Food. Yeah, hold on. I'm going to hurt her.
You don't miss him, dude.
That's the same dude.
Cut it out.
I'm gonna hurt her. We're talking about Mission Impossible 8. Back to the Future.
And he just killed those little boys.
I'm gonna hurt her.
No, I'm sorry. The publishers just gave that name. I didn't give it to him. I'm doing an amazing Capote right now.
You sound like the guy from Family Guy. I know I don't belong here, but I'm just gonna fiddle right in.
My Capote is flawless.
I've never seen Capote.
No, you want a flawless impersonation.
Hiya, Georgie. Hiya, Georgie. Hiya, Georgie. I'm getting there. Hold on, just give it
you
a second.
A pirate?
Give me like 8 more times.
Right now.
Oh.
Is popcorn,
does this guy live in a pineapple under the sea?
Is popcorn your favorite? Oh, pop, 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 pop. Hiya, Georgie.
See, with the pop, 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 pop really well, but...
Robin Williams?
Up there. You still gotta get that push.
Oh, hiya, Georgie. Hiya, Georgie. Hiya, Georgie.
You're getting a little too grandma. Like, it's not bad, but there's still like a grandma ting in there.
Still can't believe Mr. Krause voiced Raiden. Still fucking can't believe it.
Hiya, Georgie.
Are you doing Tim Curry or...
He
blew us all away!
Okay, that was good. That was good.
Is it popcorn?
Oh, man, all aboard the Hispaniola.
Don't know if I know that one.
Okay, it's cool. The diamonds are here!
Okay, that one I do know. They're not going anywhere.
God, guys.
All right, I got an amazing question for everyone.
For you.
All right.
What is it, dude?
If you could go back and relive one year.
The '90s. Oh.
One year from your childhood, which year would it be and why?
Ooh.
Good question.
Where is the cutoff for childhood? What's the cutoff?
I would say up until you're a teenager. So, zero to 12. Zero to 12.
Oh. Here. You weren't a child when you were a teen?
I don't know. I mean, you asked me for a cutoff. I gave you one, and now you're just pissing all over my face?
It's a weird rule.
Look, if you want this bare bicycle thing to work out, you really need to check your attitude.
I just want a fucking paycheck. I got baby bicycles at home that fucking don't like falafel.
Yeah, we got them. Go ahead and, we got them. Go ahead.
I guess for me it'd be 2010, because, like, I'll never forget, like, the hype I had getting out of bed, like, one morning in the summer and, like, going up at the computer, and all of a sudden I just type up Mortal Kombat, like, just out of fun, and all of a sudden I see the trailer for, like, MK9, and I'm like, holy shit.
God, I feel old. I feel so
old. How old were you?
We all do after that, all right?
In this magical memory. I'm asking questions. I'm talking.
Oh, did I interrupt you?
Yes, you did.
That's odd. That must be a first.
I had a college degree when I saw the MK9 trailer for the first time.
Oh, yeah. Oh, yeah. I was 12. I was 12 when that trailer came out.
Ooh.
Yeah.
Okay, final question. If you walked to the window and looked outside, describe what you saw out there.
Like, what kind of window are we talking about?
What are you talking about?
Don't describe the window. What's outside the window?
You've made this question worse.
What's going on?
You've ruined everything.
Mortal Kombat 9 got announced. It's like, oh my god, Shao Kahn does not look like that in game. I'm pissed. What did you see outside the window?
We wasted the good surprise on you.
Sunlight? I guess.
You saw a what? A red light?
Wait, what? Like, what do you mean? Like, are you talking about, like, a metaphor?
No, the fucking window. Did you have windows?
Of course I had windows, but what does that have to do with the fucking question?
Everything. I'm trying to paint the fucking picture of your 2010.
Okay, well, I had what's a desktop. There? I had a... What was out my room window?
No, not Windows 95, dude. The actual window. The window. What's outside your house? Jesus Christ. I wasn't asking about your operating system, dude. Man, okay. All right. I get it.
A decently normal-sized neighborhood, a backyard. I'm not sure where you want it. Some sunlight. I don't know.
Okay. I'm glad they had the sun where you lived. Huh. That's cool. Okay.
It wasn't actually old neighborhood, actually.
I never really wanted to relive all my childhood years were just kind of mixed bags, honestly.
This explains everything.
Yeah, I don't... Really, like, if you asked me to relive it, like, a year, I would go, like, sophomore in high school. Like, that was the sickness. I loved that year. That's by far my favorite grade school year. And maybe follow that my senior year. But I don't know. Junior year sucked.
Man.
Like 13 and below? That's hard, man. I don't really have really positive thoughts about any of those years.
There's a reason why I chose Mortal Kombat as a part of my childhood, because, like, that's the only thing that kept it from being totally shitty.
Man. What's up?
That's just how it's been. It's... You know,
I would say, like, if the cutoff was a little later, I'd probably say 14, because that's when I bought a Dreamcast with, like, my own money I earned, like, working at, like, an uncle's fireworks stand for, like, $2 an hour. But, like, I fucking made that money, and it was tight.
I remember this one time. I played that arcade version of Teenage Mutant Ninja Turtles, the Konami one. I was really little. It was sick. Loved that game. My mind was blown. I've been such a huge TMNT fan since before I could even remember memories. I love that shit. And I was, whoa, it's a fucking video game. Get me over there. I didn't say the fuck word because, you know, but I was hyped. I was having the most fun with that game. It was sick. I was fucking twiddling the sticks and pushing the buttons and just going nuts. I was all over the place. I was kicking ass. And then it cut to the attract mode and I realized I was not even playing. That was the last. That was the best day of my childhood.
How am I doing so good?
It was, you know, man. It was a fucking pitfall. Is what it was. I was on cloud 10, and then I was on cloud suck. It was not good. It was bad. Don't recommend that. But you know.
That's rough.
You gotta learn the hard way sometimes.
I remember playing the X-Men arcade game, and like my brother got Nightcrawler, my other brother got Wolverine, and one of my friends got Cyclops, and I got fucking Dazzler, and I was so fucking pissed.
What about Colossus?
No, I don't. Was he in there? I don't know. Was he in the original arcade?
Temp, I'm gonna just throw this out there. I think you chose Dazzler, and you've repressed it.
I mean, if you want to play Dazzler over Colossus, that's cool.
It's cool.
Nice. I mean, you know what's funny? Because after I played that game, I never heard of Dazzler ever again. I'm not convinced she's real.
It's a real character.
She left the X-Men to pursue her pop career. Yeah. And she's still doing that because she is smart.
She's not just shitty Jubilee. I was like, oh, this must be Jubilee.
She's a rock star.
She's actually cooler than Jubilee because she can convert audio into explosions. So, it was pretty cool. And Avengers versus, X-Men versus Inhumans or whatever, she kind of kicked, what's that dude's ass? Black Bolt.
I do like the idea of a rock star mutant. But, you know, I think Jubilee's powers are kind of underrated. Maybe it's because I like sparks and shit, but I think the whole fireworks thing is kind of...
I wasn't trying to knock on Jubilee. I was just saying, like, I actually really like that how that worked out there with the Inhumans, because, like, they had to go fucking find Dazzler on tour. And they brought her back in to deal with Black Bolt. They're like, look, if you open that fucking mouth, she's going to blow everybody up. Don't you make a peep, dickhead. It worked.
To answer the question, I would choose 12 years old.
And then Black Bolt killed Cyclops.
Yes.
Why 12? I don't know if I have good memories of 12.
12 for me was... Wait,
were you just wanting to know the age this whole time?
No, it was a what and why.
Okay.
I was giving you the why. Once again, this would be an example of you just interrupting before I got to the point.
It's a problem. I know this.
I said 12 because it just stands out to me for the time leading up to Deadly Alliance. And, well, Deadly Alliance came out when I don't even know.
And it was all downhill from there, man.
Yeah, so that's 11 or 12-ish, but either way. Yeah, it was just a fun time, I guess. I don't know. That's the only one that jumps to my mind. Anyways, I got a question for you, Temp. I just want to know how you would feel if Nick Nolte came over to your house wearing cut-off jean shorts and just violently kicked your ass right in front of your parents.
I don't feel good about it. Like, I think if you stripped away, like, if you banana peeled, like, different elements of that scenario, it would never get better. Like, if you hit my parents on the scenario, it would still suck. If you took out the weird shorts, it would still be awful. Like, just, like fully suited, like, three-piece Nick Nolte would still scare the shit out of me.
See, I'm thinking, like, 10 years ago, you're just somewhat little temp, and Nick Nolte just rolls up into your crib and just lays the hurt on you.
That sounds like a good story, man.
The cutoff jean shorts.
Still too soon. I feel like if it was 15 years ago, it wouldn't bother me so much. I feel like I could reason with a younger Nick Nolte. But if we're talking about like post-Tropic Thunder Nick Nolte, that would scare the fuck out of me.
Yeah, he was pretty creepy in that.
Yeah, he was rough, man. He had hands.
It's still a good story.
Still a good movie. Dude, I think Tropic Thunder is hella underrated.
I watched it like 3 months ago because I just had to watch it again.
That's crazy. I did too, man. I was telling Smoke Man you need to watch that shit and he called me a bitch. I'm like, dude,
No, that was a good movie. I like that movie.
Everyone in that movie is like doing their own bit and it works. Like Jack Black, if you take everything else out, Jack Black is still fucking hilarious in that movie. I fucking love it. Ben Stiller, the whole Simple Jack bit was hilarious to me. I fucking love that. Simple Jack.
Tom Cruise was killing it.
Oh, dude, Tom Cruise was great. Even fucking Matthew McConaughey killed it. He's only in the movie for like 5 minutes.
The TiVo.
So
fucking TiVo the whole time. I got the TiVo.
Fucking God. Steve Coogan, man. He was in the movie for 5 minutes. I was like...
Steve Coogan. He's the director, right?
Yeah.
The director that blew the fuck up.
Yeah, he was good.
You're just fucking giving everybody those stupid cards of the scene, like the shot list. You're going out there, dude. We're going to fucking kick ass. Oh! It's like, wow, he's already dead. We're like 10 minutes into this movie or some shit. I want you to walk up and punch that guy in the face. What was it? The key grip.
That Coogan guy, I see him all over the place. He's really funny. He's really good at what he does. I just, he can't, that was like his only like high budget film that I can think of off the top
Who?
Of my head.
Steve Coogan?
Yeah.
He's in a lot of shit, man.
Yeah, but he's always bit roles. I remember him mostly from Curb Your Enthusiasm. Curb Your Enthusiasm. That's where he always kind of stuck out of my mind as a therapist.
He does a bunch of English stuff, though, because he's British. That might be the thing.
That sounds right.
He hasn't crossed over to the MCU yet. They're working on it.
Even Jay. I don't know his last name, but the guy who plays Jay, like, in Knocked Up,
Yeah, he was good.
What would you do if Marilyn Manson, like, you woke up randomly in your in the middle of the Marilyn Manson staring over you, and he says... I want to know what's inside you.
I actually wouldn't be that bothered. I've seen like enough Larry King interviews with fucking Marilyn or Marilyn Manson. Yeah, it wouldn't bother me. Yeah, Charles Manson would be a different story. That would scare the fuck out of me. But Marilyn Manson, no, dude, that guy's a fucking nerd.
Yeah, they're very like brothers that don't even like act like brothers.
Is this 90s Manson or current Manson?
It's up to you.
Okay, like, then I'm going to have to go with 90s Manson.
If it was current Manson, I'd be like, hey, remember that time you got bodied by that fucking amp stack?
Here's a good one.
Or I'd just be like, fucking stay out of my pantry.
Would you rather watch a 2-hour movie of your best past memories or watch a
5 hours?
I'm done.
No. I'm actually curious. Go on. I want to know this. This is good.
Okay, go ahead.
Or watch a 5-minute trailer of your future.
Oh
gosh, that's easy. The former. I do not want to see a 5-minute trailer of my future. Like
30 years
that
from
would
now.
Scare the shit out of me. Like
sad temp.
I'm just alone with fucking like
still
I don't
doing
cancer.
The same
like,
job.
No,
still everything is the same.
I have bags under my eyes. I'm like super fat. Like I don't want to do it, man.
Balding and everything.
What kind of future are we following here? Are we talking about like a religious scenario where like no matter what you do, it's just gonna end up being that way?
Or I feel like
a future I can see, but I can change.
Even if it's like some form of fatalism where I can't change it, I still would not want to see it. Like regardless, either or, even if I could change it, I feel like that'd be even worse because now the pressure's on, bitches. Like I don't want to do it. No, I can't. I would definitely want to watch a 2-hour movie, My Best Memories. That sounds way fucking better.
I don't know why, but it seems like, you know, the point of you being an insurance guy, working in insurance is a factor here somewhere.
Yeah, probably. Like, I don't like liability.
But I feel like that should mean that you would want to see the future a little bit.
Dude.
It's okay. It's fine.
Like, the biggest part of my job is just interpreting, like, contracts and shit and telling people we can't pay them. Like, that's really the biggest part of my job. The insurance part is actually super secondary. It's really just the contract work and, like, doing clerical stuff in people's files. I like it a lot better. The worst part of my fucking job is when the phone rings. Like, that's the only part of my job I don't like.
I hate that part, too.
Like, if I didn't have to talk to randos, like, I'd be much... happier.
I hate randos so much. They're so stupid and I hate everybody. Anyway.
I enjoy paying people too. I like issuing payments when I'm able to, but go on, sir.
It would be shitty if you didn't, especially since it's not your money, right?
No.
It's like, hey man, fucking I get to be that guy who's dead. Like, here, you get a car and you're supposed to... I don't know what you're talking about. Want the trailer. That's what I want.
This is just a horrible question.
What do you got?
It's a loose situation.
Everyone picked the trailer, right? Let's be clear. Everyone picked the... Wait, no. Reverse that.
You didn't pick the trailer.
I totally not pick the trailer.
I would take the movie. I'd take the 2-hour movie.
Why the fuck would you take the trailer, Django?
I feel like watching the movie would depress me even further, knowing I can't relive the trailer.
I feel like the trailer is the only option that's useful.
I mean, technically, you can relive a lot of your memories through photographs and stuff already as it is, but...
If it's the movie is just a fucking rerun. Fuck that.
I've got a great question for Temp to get back for the cousin fucker for Django.
Let's do it. What do we got?
He judged you so hard. It was great. It's a lose-lose. So
I just stated my preference.
That's it's a lose-lose, so I hope you're prepared for this.
Hit me.
You sound so excited, but you're immediately going to not be as soon as I give you this. Would you rather, if you had to, would you rather sleep with your mom or your daughter?
No, I'm not answering that. The answer is no.
I told you it was a lose-lose.
Not doing it.
There's no good answer there. But seriously, though, if you had to take one for the team, which one are you choosing?
I'm not going to answer that. The answer is no, I'm not doing it. I will die. I will just die. I will take the death. I will harakiri.
Oh my God.
I will grab the samurai sword and I'll apologize to everyone. And I'll do what I got to do.
Like, I didn't even think of harakiri. Damn.
Harakiri is always an option. Always.
It wasn't on the paper.
Anyone who tells you otherwise has an agenda.
Yeah, Cyborg has an agenda.
I found a way out, sir. I dug my way out.
So you've chosen option three of just killing yourself.
Yes, of course.
You would rather die.
Obviously, that answer is less entertaining.
No old boy for you.
Oh, that's a good movie.
Yes. All right. Yeah, that's it. That's done. It's over.
Would you rather
shoot
a vampire or wizard?
Which wing do you like better? The legs or the wing thing? You know what I'm talking about?
The flats by far, dude. Like, there's no contest in my opinion.
So you're a flat guy. Django, would you say?
The knight.
Yep, that's not a... That's not an option.
You made that up.
You're killing yourself.
I want the Nightwing. That's what I want.
Oh, you made a pun.
Yeah, we're just going to breeze right over that.
No, I want to know. You're at Wingstop. Do you have a Wingstop where you live?
Listen, I want the good one.
Yeah, it's up to you to decide which one that is.
It's got to be flats or drumsticks, brother. You got it. It's chicken wings. You got to pick one.
I'm a flat kind of guy.
Yeah, okay, cool.
Yeah, the wife likes the wings, so you know it works out.
Yeah. I probably have to go for the wings too.
Which drumstick or
drumsticks?
Flats. Love it. You prefer drumsticks, yeah.
Yeah.
See, I that's a tough choice cuz I like them both, but yeah, I don't know.
I like all the flavors in the flat, dude. I feel like the flat just like nets all the flavor. The drumstick is like an optical illusion where you bite into it and it's like all fucking cartilage and bone. It's like, this is bullshit. Yeah,
I will say the flat is more fun to eat. Like you get that fun little, like you pinch it with you. Like, then you're like you're fingering the other side to push the meat out. It's good. the flat's a fun time.
Dude, I don't know how you eat your flat, but I break the bone by the side.
I don't do that.
Split it out and then dip that shit. It's so good.
Yeah, I don't break it. I just, like I said, I push it through with my fingers. It's good.
You just fucking you debone it with the one hand trick, the whole thing.
Yeah, I'm not that tricky with.
Yeah, even I don't. I take one bone out. I can't fully debone.
You're like, you take the bra off and.
I mean, you guys need to work on your straps, bro.
In the front.
Get good.
It's all in the technique.
It is. It's in the wrist too.
Look at that wrist.
Yep.
Sorry, old meme. I should be ashamed of myself.
What? Now I want some chicken wings.
I want some chicken wings.
I mean, I'm literally cooking right now as we speak, but I'm still kind of hungry.
Cooking at 3 fucking a.m.
Why is there something weird about me? Something that I do that no one else does?
No.
Okay.
Well, what is it? I doubt it's that weird. That's what I meant.
No, it's not super weird. I mean, it's weird in the fact that no one does it, but I don't think you would be offended or anything.
I'm offended already.
I hope it's offensive.
Nah, you guys are going to be disappointed, but... What I do is I refrigerate my potato chips. Once I open the bag, I don't bother with the clamp. I just throw that shit in the
refrigerator. I am highly offended right now.
What the fuck did I just hear?
Yeah, see, you shouldn't have probed him.
Wow. I completely misjudged.
I do grab it, though. But I do stick my potato chips in the refrigerator.
You know, I have a saying. You do what you do. If it doesn't hurt anyone, it's fine.
Now, I have a saying of don't do that. Stop it.
Do you guys not like cold chips?
Brought me into your world, and so now it is hurting me.
I mean, I don't personally like refrigerating my chips, but if you do that, that's...
If I'm lying, I'm dying.
No, I believe you. That's the problem.
No, I mean, it's a fact. I'm not going to...
I mean,
I
listen.
I can go back on it now.
Fucking overshare.
I mean, honestly, it's not like a flavor thing. I don't like bugs. I know
that would be really weird if it was a flavor thing.
I'm with you 100% on the bugs. I don't like bugs, but
Let me tell you,
my pasta and my chips are all in my refrigerator because I know there's no way the bugs are gonna open the fucking door. That's why I do it.
I mean, that is a solid strategy.
That sounds like some.
You make a good
some form of mania.
I mean, I'm pretty bugophobic when it comes to food and drink.
I'm super bugophobic, dude. Like, everything that's resealable goes in the fridge.
I mean, if I can seal it, I'm good. Like, I don't worry about it if it seals. But if I leave like a drink open or a cup of water sitting somewhere and I walk away for an extended period of time, I'm throwing that away as soon as I get back. doubly if it's outside. Like, if I leave a pop can outside and I walk away for 15 minutes, I'm not drinking the rest of it. I don't care how full it's.
Yeah,
going.
Open soda. Like, I need both eyes on that at all times, especially if I'm outdoors.
That's what I'm saying. We are one and the same on that.
I can't help it.
I know, it's just not happening. I don't want to drink bug water. Like, I just...
Or even worse, what if it's not my soda? Like, what if it's like, it feels emptier than it did when I last drank it? I'm like, oh no.
You see, that's always my biggest fear is if I, especially when I'm around like in a party or I leave a drink around, I'm never going to touch. That's going to be mine.
You're
cutting
drink
out of it.
You're cutting.
Yeah, I got a third of that, bro.
Oh, I got it, man. I got it.
I think your voice sensitivity is too high or something. It's cutting off some of it.
I got it.
He's got it.
Yeah, Django's got it. That's good.
I got it.
But yeah, what I was saying is like, this is why like in parties or like when I'm at the park with like friends and family, like if I like walk and I walk away somewhere, if I come back, I'm not touching that soda because I don't know if it's mine or someone drank out of it.
I want you to scream in my face right now.
I don't got the park part.
Oh, I can't do that because I'm going to have one crashing through my door yelling at me.
Yeah, that's not good. I got that too.
Here's a question, Eshi. What happens if you do say no to a Persian parent?
Good question.
Let me try it.
We just don't know.
let's get it live.
Science has not come this far yet.
You might get the leather belt.
Did somebody just eat an entire salad in one bite? What was that?
No.
Django, you just ate a whole salad, didn't you?
I will not do that.
Are there croutons in there?
Sounds good.
How dare you eat your favorite vegetable right in front of us right now?
You'll get the camembert.
Are we pink lemonade or regular lemonade, guys?
I like regular. Honestly, I do really enjoy pink lemonade, and honestly, I like it because it's a little less acidic. But I just never get it. I don't have any partial reason to regular lemonade. I just always go regular.
Yeah,
I'm an iced tea guy. Actually, if I have a choice, I'm gonna go iced tea. Really, every time.
You know,
I never saw the appeal of iced tea. To be honest.
Oh, I knew it. I knew there was gonna be someone in there.
I mean, sweetened tea is the shit. I mean, I love it.
Again, this is coming from a Persian. I like my tea hot and.
I do too. I like
tea
hot as well.
Stuff too.
Especially
but
sweet.
My wife hates all tea, and I don't get it. I don't get that.
Especially Mr. Tea.
It's really fucking. You know. No, he's not really your type. She's more into like
She's a Mexican
dudes. What? Yeah. Dude, I have a question for you, Ishii.
Mm-hmm.
Tell me where exactly Persia is. I was debating whether or not I was going to ask, but I want to know.
Well, I want to know. Can you show me?
You should fuck up. We're learning here.
See, I got a completely different song in my head. We said I want to know. I got the whole, and I'm here.
Let's fucking learn something for 5 goddamn minutes.
Oh, is it awful when somebody interrupts what you're trying to fucking say?
I am trying to better myself over here to learn some shit.
Well, Persia is not Persia anymore. It's called Iran. It's just people call it Persian because it sounds cooler.
See, that's what I want. Well, I don't call it Persia because I didn't know where that was. I know where Iran is.
Yeah. Well, I mean, like, around
and
like
so
the third...
far away.
Around, but like... is that the extent of old Persia? Is just all that's now Iran?
Oh, God, no. Persia.
Oh, it was bigger.
Giant empire, like it spanned all the way from Bulgaria all the way to like modern day Tajikistan, which is like Central Asia and shit. It was a big empire.
Fascinating. See, it's good questions. Yep. My uncle's Iranian, and yes, and he would never talk about Persia. That sounds way creepier than it is. But I just never asked him, and so now I'm glad I'm getting the chance. It's like crazy random happenstance. All right.
Yeah.
I'm glad to know. See, I'm not ignorant anymore.
Yep.
Still pretty ignorant.
All right, I got a dark question. Who wants it?
I want it.
Dark?
Man, you just don't know what you're getting yourself into. You chose the third option last time that didn't exist. Well, fine.
You may not want to pick me because I can always harakiri out of the question, so I may not be your best contestant. But I'm interested. I'm curious what you got.
Would you rather have your parents stuffed in your living room, like taxidermy style?
Okay.
Or have to snort their ashes after they have been cremated.
That's like that movie, Dude. Right?
I mean, snorting ashes wouldn't be like... Yeah. I think just having to snort ashes is the problem. Like, I don't...
It's harakiri. I can't.
God damn
it. Yeah.
You know what? I feel like snorting ashes will get it over.
At least it's done, yes.
I'll take the snorting ashes. For 500.
You are just consuming their essence. It's like the Big Lebowski where he opens the coffee can and it just goes all over. I love that movie.
It's a good movie.
I feel like depending on the quality of the taxidermy, like that's going to stay with you for a while. It's going to be around. You got to remember it day in, day out. You got to ask, you got to not ask questions. You should ask questions. You have to answer questions about it too. And you might go to jail.
Right.
But, if you consume the evidence...
Have y'all done the cinnamon test? I don't think it's as easy as you guys think. I think, like, when you put that much dry matter inside your body, it's...
Yeah,
cinnamon challenge?
You're gonna need some milk in there.
Yeah, it's hard. The cinnamon challenge is a...
Is something... Did you do it?
Oh, yeah, I've done it a couple of times, actually.
Why?
These people are like, hey, I bet you can't do a spoonful of cinnamon. I'm like, bitch. And then I eat the spoonful of cinnamon.
You're right. No one would do that. That's why it's funny. This is a stupid idea. I'm not funny. Listen, I've never been accused once of being funny.
That's fair. I mean, fun's overrated, to tell you the truth, man. I think...
I'm just like, dude, it's fucking... You want to see me cough and gag and freak out? Does that sound like fun? And then they're like, yeah. I'm like, you guys suck. Listen, what was I going to say? Oh, nope, I forgot.
Would you rather be on the FBI's terrorist suspect list or your local police department's sex offender registry?
Oh, FBI, easily.
Yeah, dude.
Yeah, easily.
At least with the FBI, you get some, like, notoriety. Like
yeah.
Fucking bad.
I get to grow my beard out. Like, that'd be tight.
Well, being there's like any sort of like,
I get to be like
even if someone suggests that, especially if you're a dude, if someone suggests that you've done some sex criminal shit, that shit's for life. You don't even gotta have evidence about that shit. It's just like, do you see that guy over there? For life, that sticks right there. For life. Don't do it. Bring it on, FBI.
Yeah, if I go to jail for being a terrorist, it's just like, oh, that guy's in jail for terrorism. If you go to jail for being a sex offender, dude, that's a bad day. That is
awful. Embarrassing.
It's embarrassing.
It's embarrassing. That's true.
That's such an interesting perspective on it, but yes, you're right. It's just...
I bet it would be harder to get a job with the sex offender than the terrorist. Like, I think the terrorist would be able to get a job more easily.
I guess people would offer you a job. Like, you could be part of a think tank if you're a terrorist or something. Like,
I get to be Kano.
Man.
Would you rather never be able to stop eating Django or never be able to stop talking Django?
Why are we eating Django?
Which one is it?
I don't know.
That's hard, too. Those are both bad. I would hate both of those, man.
At least one of those is a better chance of surviving. Like, if you, like, constantly get, like, the cravings and like, the food, like, the world's food supply runs out, what are you gonna do?
Would you rather live as a hoarder or a heroin addict?
Hoarder. You don't die of hoarding.
Just your pets, and you'll live with a house filled with, like, cockroaches and nasty shit.
Wait a minute. That's a good question.
Thank you. I don't know. What do you want me to say?
At least with heroin
addict or hoarder, you say?
You want... No, whether you live as a hoarder or a heroin addict. Not who would you rather live with.
Damn. Like, if I was a heroin addict, but I had some heroin, a quality of life is going to be higher than the other one.
I feel like one of those is easier to rehabilitate.
Yeah, the heroin.
Yeah, so take the heroin.
Listen, man, I'm into it. Listen, I have a thing with smells. I'm not into smells. Smells, like, freak me out. They're too much. And hoarders stink.
Yeah.
And that shit, you ain't getting it out. That shit's for life. All those fucking dead cats or whatever.
Mm-hmm.
Would you rather be the best magician in the world or the best gambler in the world?
Ooh, gambler. No, wait, magician. Magician, that's not a hard one. I don't know why I fucking picked the gambler.
Wait.
Magician.
Can I do actual magic?
We're done
or,
here.
Or is this some Las Vegas shit?
We're done here.
Am I Chris Angel or David Blaine?
Both.
You're
a hybrid.
David Blaine is really good at acting like he needs to throw up. Chris Angel spends a lot of time in the mirror. Gambler. Definitely. Every time.
Would you take $2 million tax-free on the condition that you can never earn any more money ever again?
Yeah, I live in Arkansas. That's totally doable, man.
I could live many years off of that.
That's a good question. Why? Are you needing to unload some? That's...
Yeah.
You can talk to me after the show. You need to launder some funds.
We'll talk. We'll stay in
I
touch.
I like it. I like it. It's good shit. I'm still thinking about this chip.
We've
in the
already
fridge
said
situation.
Too much. Chip in the fridge. Yeah, that's that. I didn't want to say it too much while he was here, but that's just the fucking stupidest thing. Chips in fridge. Who wants to eat cold chips?
None of you guys are one of those motherfuckers that put that's water like, on cereal, are you?
No.
Dude,
I'm the type of person that crushes up my chips, puts them in an ice cube holder, and then puts a little water in there, lets them freeze them, and then that's how I make sure there's no bugs in my chips.
Well, you don't lack conviction.
Vinegar flavored ice.
Man, those weird fucking guys who put water on their cereal that freaks me out.
That doesn't make any sense. That's gross.
It happens, dude. It's real.
You know what I have a problem with? I have a problem with people who like fucking pour the milk first then the cereal.
Ooh, that's good too.
Monsters.
That's not as bad as the milk. I mean the water.
It's like taking a shower and then shitting. You just don't do it.
Well, you know,
that is the wrong order of things.
I think that checks out. Water on your cereal. Look, you fucking Neanderthal.
Neanderthal.
Yeah, say that shit right.
You just spoke with the Persian accent, right?
You nailed it.
That's the proper pronunciation, dude.
Neanderthal.
It is.
Proper. Yeah.
It is. I wasn't trying to be a dickhead. Sometimes I am.
Was the moon landing a hoax or was it real?
I wasn't there.
If you're using science logic, if I didn't see it, I didn't hear it. I didn't smell it. It didn't happen.
I mean, you know, you can't argue that. I wasn't there. It could have happened. I don't know.
Like, did you guys know that it takes time for light to travel? So whenever you're seeing the sun, you're seeing it 8 seconds in the past?
Yeah.
Would you rather be hit by lightning or be bitten by a shark?
Hit by lightning. I think that'd be badass.
Have one of those, like, fucking burn patterns that's in the shape of lightning bolts.
Yep.
That's one of the fucking stupidest questions I've ever heard. Who would want to get bit by a shark?
Would you rather live in the 1700s or the 2700s?
Do you want to fucking, you know, be Shazam, or do you want to get eaten alive? Come on!
I don't know the future, if it'll be shitty or good, but at the same time, I don't want to live in an era where disease was, like, prevalent everywhere. So that's a hard one, too.
So you don't want to be in the past, is what you're saying?
Well, I mean, it kind of depends where.
Would you rather be a pen or a pencil?
Definitely don't want to be anywhere in, like, you know, the European locations whenever they were struggling with every disease ever.
Would you rather fight Chuck Norris or Mike Tyson?
They did have potatoes in their fridge.
I feel like... maybe I'll go against Chuck Norris, because at least I'm not losing my ear.
Yeah, because Mike Tyson, I think, was, like, stronger than Chuck Norris. Man, Mike Tyson could kill me, still. That dude's scary. Chuck Norris, as far as I'm concerned, he's an actor.
Would you rather go against Kimbo Slice or Dwayne Johnson?
Mm-mm. Oh, Dwayne Johnson, just so I can meet him.
I'd rather go against Kimbo Slice because he's dead.
Wait, what? He is?
Yes.
Wait, what?
He died.
You're fucking lying. You're lying to me.
Is that
true? I'm not lying. He died like a year or two ago.
No, wait, no, you're fucking lying. Wait a second.
That doesn't sound quite right, but...
Sorry, bro.
No.
Oh, jeez.
He was a great man.
I just ruined your life. I know, I'm sorry. It happens.
Oh my god, 2016 is that same year every fucking celebrity.
I'm back.
I mean, I guess had Kimbo break, Slice is a celebrity.
I just had to break the news to Issue that Kimbo Slice is dead. Because he asked me which I'd rather fight, Kimbo Slice or The Rock, and I said Kimbo Slice.
I don't know if I know who that is.
It's okay.
See? I told you.
I might be Googling him now.
I know who Kimbo Slice is, but
it's blood. It's blood from Drake and Josh.
In Inception, Cobb is back to reality or is stuck in the limbo?
Back. He's back.
Dwayne Johnson.
He's gotta be back. I need him to be back, alright?
I'd be okay if he wasn't back. I just think he's back.
He's back. Come on.
He was never gone.
He's back.
Alright, I have a question for you, Cyborg.
I'm the one that answers. I ask the questions, okay?
It's a good question. You're gonna
the question asker. You're the.
It's a hard one.
Can I just harakiri?
You can, if you want to.
When in doubt, carry it out.
I don't think you will, though. I don't think you will. I think you will choose.
All right, do it.
All right, you can get $5 million, but fall and spring are permanently gone, and all you have left is summer and winter.
It's kind of tough, because you know that fall and spring are my favorite.
I do know that.
Wow.
You're a monster.
So what will you do, sir?
So they're just gone. Like, I can't move anywhere, obviously. They're just they're out. It's either
summer is March all the way to like November.
It's
now.
Either like quite hot and humid, or it's cold and freezing and icy and but $5 million, you can do a lot with that.
You can, yeah.
Especially in Arkansas.
We get it. All right, it's cheap.
You can buy a lot of beef jerky with $5 million.
Cost of living is very, very low. And we made Walmart.
And
is there a correlation?
So does that mean
maybe?
Like
you made all the Clintons?
So the seasons are out, but I mean, like, do storms still happen? Do like rainfall, is that still a thing? Is like thunderstorms still a thing?
Occasionally.
Does Halloween still happen? I mean, there's more layers to this, I guess, that I have to analyze.
Yeah, you get to keep this. You get to keep the holidays. I'm not gonna.
It's
take
just the actual weather that's gone, like the that fun, crisp feeling in fall and that nice feeling in spring.
It's gone unless you don't take the $5 million.
Yeah, I feel like I'll just take the $5 million and stop working. Yep.
I mean, I empathize with the answer, but even from someone who doesn't really have like viable seasons, we really just have summer and sort of fall in Texas, at least South Texas. I would still want to keep the seasons. I don't know if I can get rid of. I like fall and spring too much, at least in principle.
God, you're too nice.
I mean, I want the seasons. Trust me, I want the seasons. But the idea of not having to work another day in my life and just living a modest life sounds wonderful. I like the idea of not having to have that commitment, that obligation.
You're gonna be like the guy from Office Space.
I believe you. I was told that I could listen to this at a reasonable volume.
I didn't think about that too. I was like, which guy from Office Space?
That's the last straw. I'm burning down the building.
I have a question for you.
As a no salt.
Nice cash, fuck broke as shit, doesn't do shit.
As a no salt. No salt.
Do you remember when we did Office Space character matches? Do y'all remember that?
Oh, yes.
It's okay. Last year I did.
I remember that it was unanimous who Razor was.
he was Michael Bolton.
It was not even hard.
Would you guys rather have no girlfriend for life or a robot girlfriend?
No girlfriend? So basically,
I either way, I get no girlfriend for life. I feel regardless.
So it's like live with a robot or live with no one? What are you trying to put on me here?
Look at number,
are you a robot? Are you trying to put the robot race on us? Are you trying to? Do you work for Skynet?
Yeah, I'm recording all this data right now.
I knew
it. He's a robot salesman,
he's
man.
He's a spy.
He meet his quota.
I don't even think like having a robot girlfriend is like the worst thing in the world. As long as you get to have an additional real girlfriend in like plus the robot girlfriend, I don't think that's really. I don't
really
think,
that your real girlfriend's gonna go for that shit.
I think I could find a girlfriend who would. I don't think I'd like her very much. I think she'd
like exactly.
I'd prefer none then. I don't think I could live with a robot. I feel like that would get really creepy and weird.
I'm afraid my real girlfriend would like my robot girlfriend more than she would like me, and that would make me very self-conscious.
It kind of depends on the robot. If it's like
I'm glad that you said that, because that was what I was about to ask. Like, is this robot a little more R2-D2, or are they a little bit more C3?
No.
Is this like some Will Robinson shit, or is like she hot?
Because I mean, like a Roomba is like a robot. So what are we talking about?
Like we're talking like advanced, like self-aware robots. Like it looks like a chick. Like it
does she act like a chick? Is she like I'm a robot, or did she like fucking like?
No, like no, it's like it acts like a chick, but it just has a robot voice.
Dude, give me a.
It's a robot voice.
Give me a.
It's gonna be a deal breaker by itself. Yeah, go on, Jingo.
No, yeah, just give me a pop culture reference so I know what you're talking about. Like,
that's okay.
I mean, it was like the Blade Runner like 2049 robot. Yeah, I mean that basically is a real girlfriend. Like,
I got a good question.
It's great.
If you had
I gotta get to the. Come on, man! I'm trying to figure out what I'm doing for the rest of my life.
It's hard for me to name a film about this, but.
Like Vision, like a female Vision. Is that what she's like?
Like a female Paul Bettany?
Kind of, yeah. Basically, like a robot chick. Like, it has, like, hair and everything. Like, it has, like... it has like, human-looking skin. Like, it's obviously not fucking real skin.
But dude, she looks like a girl. Like, she's just a girl. She looks like a girl.
it looks like a human chick, but it's a robot. It has a robot voice. It sounds like a robot.
But it has a robot voice. You gotta give me a reference. Are we talking? Because, you know, like, if you watched Her, that movie, that was just Scarlett Johansson's voice, but she was a robot. That would be cool.
Okay, yeah, just imagine Scarlett Johansson's voice, but robotic. Like fucking Siri or Cortana. Okay, Cortana's a good example. Like, Cortana. Think Cortana.
Now, we're getting somewhere.
That's like a person, though. Like, I don't feel like that's the biggest loss. Like, if she's just like, hey, Temp, you're cool that I'm a robot, right? That doesn't bother you that I'm a robot? But if she's like, self-destruct, like, no, I don't want to do that. That's fucked
up. Yeah, if she sounds like a Dalek, then fuck that.
No. Nothing like that. Like, it's...
Could have just said the, like, girl on Blade Runner 2040, whatever.
Okay, let's go
with Blade Runner. I did say that, though, right?
I wasn't even listening to you guys, all right?
Listen.
What's your question, Cyborg?
I'm coming clean.
You have the floor. What do you got for me?
I've just been waiting to speak. That's it.
Okay. Hit me. New question.
Two questions. The first one's a quick one. Would you rather have to wear a bicycle helmet wherever you go or carry an open umbrella everywhere you go?
Open umbrella. Fuck yeah. I'd be a boss, dude.
I would wear
a suit too. It would be fucking sick.
It's gotta be cool. Open everywhere you go, though. It's not like you're.
That'd be cool. That means I get to fly with it.
Do I have like a posse?
That's not what that means. That's not.
The umbrella makes you fly?
No, that's not part of this.
It's a magic umbrella.
All right, the serious one. This is gonna be a tough one. You had to sleep with Leonardo DiCaprio.
God damn it.
Like Titanic version? Or now version?
Titanic version, that's easy.
This is a trap. This is a trap, and she went right for it. I like it. This is good. That was a good one.
Wait a second.
Titanic or now? Do you want like more grown-up badass Leonardo?
Do you want to fuck a dude,
or do you want to fuck like, you know, like a fucking androgynous,
like
dude?
A hairless boy? Yes.
I want to go now. If I had to pick, I don't want to pick either of them, but I'd go now. At least you'd protect me from bears and shit.
You know, I only would choose now because I actually like Leonardo now, whereas when he was in Titanic form, I was like, man, this guy's annoying.
Titanic form? Like he evolved like a Pokemon?
Yes. Yes. So I'm taking the one that's more tolerable. He's been in a lot of good films. The Departed. The Departed where he won me over.
The Departed?
I still need to watch that. I have not seen that yet.
That one's good. And then he was in a few. Shutter Island, Inception. I
haven't seen that one either.
It was all
right. What do you call it? Django Unchained?
Yep. He was inside me.
All right. Well, it looks like you've already made your choice in the past.
Long time ago.
So you chose then.
Ian and Jamie Foxx both. All right.
Okay. So we got two nows, a then, and what'd you say, Django?
Well, that's what I'm trying to think. Like you're saying we got Titanic, and that's a very defined version of Leo DiCaprio. The current one is less so.
What's eating Gilbert Grape? Whatever, you know?
Yeah, that's a whole other... Whoa. let's not eating Gilbert Grape.
I'm just saying. It's just that period of his career or now.
Do you want to go Growing Pains, Leonardo DiCaprio? Or you want to go... What was that one movie? Wolf of Wall Street. Let's do that one.
Okay, there you go. Yep.
Wolf of Wall Street, Leonardo DiCaprio. He's rich. Jack was broke as shit.
There you go. Chosen.
I have a question.
We have three now and one then. What's your question?
Would you rather be in a movie that is mediocre but it's directed by Michael Bay, or would you rather direct a movie but your leading actors are Stephen Baldwin and Kevin Spacey?
Stephen Baldwin, Kevin Spacey.
So you want to direct?
Yeah, I fucking hate Michael Bay. Fuck that.
I don't know what I would. I mean, that's I made
I would
the question.
Take
I star. Think
oh, I'd take easily take starring. Wait, you said something about a Martin Scorsese?
No. Oh, Michael Bay was the director.
So you're starring in a movie made by Michael Bay, or
and directed.
Right. And then yeah. What was the other one? Or you direct a movie with Alec Baldwin?
Stephen Baldwin.
Spacey?
Oh no, dude, we're not going this high, Alec. You got to take it down a notch, sir.
Whatever.
Stephen is the proper Baldwin in the scenario.
Encino Man or whatever the fuck. Anyways.
You're close. He's in Biodome, but yeah.
I know. I get him mixed up. But Encino Man was Brendan Fraser.
Yeah, dude, actually, like, if I had directed a movie with, like, fucking, like, Sean Astin and Pauly Shore and Brendan Fraser, I don't think that's a bad deal. I'd do that.
I would take easily, hands down, star in the movie made by Michael Bay because, granted, yes, he's made a lot of shit. But one, if he's directing, it's probably going to be a big blockbuster. So I'm getting the recognition right there. Two, I get to do cool shit in the movie, like blow shit up all the time. And three, he's actually made some good films in the past. So, like Bad Boys.
He did The Rock, too. I thought
The Rock
was good.
The Rock and Bad Boys. I love those movies.
At least I think he did The Rock. I could be wrong. I'm pretty sure he did The Rock. The Rock pretty actually sure is a too. Really good movie.
Yeah, he's done good stuff in the past, just nothing lately. But either way, I'll still take it. He's got name recognition. I'd rather do that than fucking direct a movie that nobody's going to give it a shit about. I'd rather star in
depends
very shallow blockbuster that's a huge blockbuster that's probably critically not great.
Loved that film.
You're directing it, not writing it. Oh, shit.
Directing it, whatever.
I mean,
either
it's
way,
still,
no one's going to give a shit about that movie.
I don't know if anyone caught on, but I would not want to work with Kevin Spacey. Like, even with all the shit recently that happened wasn't the case, that guy's probably the biggest dick in the... And, like, that guy's probably, like King Douchebag, I think, all the way. Like, I would not want to work with that dude.
Yeah. I get that vibe, yeah.
Well, it's almost my time.
It's that time in general.
Yeah. It's about, I gotta go finish my chicken.
Somebody's using a typewriter, so.
Guess what time is it?
Hi!
It's MK News.
I've never
the greatest
done anything.
Day of them all. All right.
I got a question.
What's
this
the
is
question?
A serious one.
All right, go for it.
I've asked no questions this entire night. God damn it. I've been waiting. It's about to blast off.
You
okay.
Hear what's happening right now? Silence.
This place
good.
Is about to blow.
What do you got? We're listening.
Listen.
Sorry.
Temp.
Uh-huh.
Shh. Cyborg. Would you rather... No, this is definitely for Ishii. This is definitely for Ishii. Would you rather have...
Anytime.
Okay. Actual. Have.
Yep.
Mortal Kombat 1-3 HD done by a different studio completely that didn't do any of those old ones that we saw the leak. Whole new deal. Or would you rather have Shaolin Monks 2?
That's a good one. So is it like MK1-3 like the whole game remastered? Like,
yeah,
like,
rebalance?
Like in one package?
Are they going to fix the glitches?
MK1, yeah, like... MK2, and UMK3 is what you're getting.
Okay.
And you can play a classic mode and a rebalanced mode in each and every one of them.
But like, what about like the art direction?
Ooh, that's, to me, that's easy. But go on, Ishii. I'll let you have the floor.
Like, what was the question?
Like, but like, is like from an art direction, like graphically, is it also upgrade thing? Like, anything about it is
yeah, it's HD, it's remade. It's not just fucking it's not an upscale, it's not stretching. This ain't no arcade collection bullshit. The shit is remade.
That's a good question. Or Shaolin Monks 2. Well, I didn't really play the classic games like religiously as someone who grew up with the console era. Call me a heretic.
There's no wrong answer here. I think.
Shaolin Monks 2, though, that would be... Like... You know, I'm... That is a fucking tough one.
I know.
I guess I'll take Shaolin Monks 2, just because, like... I've always said this, and I really like the whole aspect of exploring the Mortal Kombat universe. I always wanted another open world Mortal Kombat game where I like explore the Living Force, the portal, all that stuff. And I think Shaolin Monks 2 would be a great way to explore more realms or something like that.
I had a feeling that's what you were gonna say.
Yeah.
Yeah, me too.
You think so? You say this is the same thing, Shaolin Monks 2?
I was just saying I figured that's what he'd go with.
Oh.
Yeah.
It makes
so you would rather have the HD thing?
Me?
Yeah.
I don't know, it's a tough choice. It's a tough choice indeed. Like I want Shaolin Monks 2 because I want something different. But I mean, I am a fan of MK2 and Ultimate Mortal Kombat 3. I mean, Ultimate Mortal Kombat 3 for me is what I played for years. Anytime a friend wanted to play MK, that was the go-to up until MK9.
This ain't like me asking you about fucking your cousin. This is serious.
Yeah, I got a question for you real quick. Would you rather be shot or stabbed? Just out of random, nothing.
Where am I being stabbed?
I don't know.
All right, shot.
All right, good to know.
Yep.
I'll just notate that down.
Mm-hmm.
All right.
Good. Don't get that wrong.
At least with the stab, you don't have to worry about taking a bullet out of you.
Well, you may not have to worry about that with the bullet either, depending on how they do.
Well, that's the thing. Like, you asked where to be stabbed. You never said where you're being shot either. Like, it could be somewhere, like...
That's like true.
Your shoulder or something where you have to,
that
like,
shit's
take
like
the
so
bullet out.
Fast, though. Like, the knife, like, they just might suck and hit some kind of weird thing and then twist. And, like, just... No.
They can stab you in the head.
Well,
case, I think in my case, because I'm like lean and like skinny, I think the bullet just might go right through.
All right. On that note, we're done here.
Wait, we didn't get Temp's answer.
Well, we know Temp's going for the HD remaster. If Shad and Razor were here, Shad would choose the HD remaster. Razor would choose Shaolin Monks hands down. I'm on the fence. Django, you would go with the HD remaster. Boom, got you all figured out. See you guys next time.
No, that's true. I heard some fucking bullshit in there.
I'm just telling you, that's the answers.
I would really like to play like UMK3 with all the glitches gone and fucking like Kabon Kung Lao toned down. Although I think Shadow would pick Shaolin Monks 2, to be honest with you. I think Shadow.
I don't know. Shad was like a huge fan of the original trilogy. I mean, he still enters tournaments on the 2D game, like the old 2D games. I feel like that's his... He might be on the fence like me, but I feel like he's going to lean remaster. I don't know. Either way.
Did you pick an answer?
Me?
Yeah, you.
I just...
Or are you still on the fence?
I don't know. It's that's
tough. You get off the fence, for God... Come on, man.
Well, okay, I'll choose.
I'm lacking conviction here. Pick one.
I would choose just to do Shaolin Monks 2 because I feel like if I want to play an MK game, I don't really need to go back to the past. I've played the past for the last like 20 years. I want MK11. I don't need a redo of the games.
Well, you're
that
not
I've
getting MK11
played.
Here. That's not an option.
I know.
Shaolin Monks 2.
No, that's what I'm saying. Okay, Shaolin Monks 2. Okay, well, yeah, if it's in place of MK11, yeah, definitely Shaolin Monks 2.
No, it's not in place of MK11. What are you talking about?
You just told me to... I'm not getting MK11. What are you saying?
I'm saying this would not be MK11. Like, this is
I understand.
Deal.
Okay, but it would be alongside, right? Like,
I don't know. Maybe.
You're saying,
or maybe,
like...
what if it was UMK3 fucking done like they did with MK2? It was the fucking Double Dragon version of UMK3.
I'm just saying, I don't like. I would like a remaster. I think that would be cool, but I feel like it's only going to have so much mileage. I feel like it's one of those novelty things where it's like, okay, this is cool. I would like to play this. I'd play it for like 30 hours. It's like, but then I'd feel like I'm just playing the old games again, and I'd rather progress. I want to see MKX, but done better. I don't want to see MK2, but done better. I guess is what I'm saying.
Okay, so with Shaolin Monks 2, there's more unique content
it's
in
just,
that
yeah,
package.
Different. It's just okay. A different approach. I like options, I guess. I don't know, variety.
It is a very understandable answer. I'm with you. Good. There's not enough looking ahead in Mortal Kombat, but there's also not enough looking outside of one's... No, it's a good... Okay, whatever. Yeah, I don't know what I'm talking about. It's good. Well done. Proud of you.
It's always nice to experience a franchise you like in different ways, and that's what was so cool about Shaolin Monks, the first one, is if you're not good at a fighting game, like I have friends, a lot of my friends aren't good at fighting games, but they like Mortal Kombat. And
friends.
Yes, plural. There are multiple there. but they are not good at fighting games. They never were. And it's like they would get frustrated playing me, and I wasn't that good. And it's like they'd get frustrated playing me and they wouldn't have fun playing it. They would never buy the games. They would just play it at my house because they didn't like fighting games that much to warrant buying it themselves. But Shaolin Monks, they liked because it's all the fun of MK characters that they like and the story and the theme, but in a means that they can play. It's more casual friendly or fun or whatever.
I'm with you. I think Shaolin Monks 2 is the kind of shit that keeps a marriage alive.
Yeah, honestly, I think that's one of the reasons. Like, I'd really like another action adventure MK game. Like, one personally, I'm not the best at fighting games myself, and I like generally prefer like more open world like explorability. And I think another like open world Mortal Kombat game would be like really, because it also expands the audience, and it's something for my own little personal pleasure of just playing. So yeah, I totally get you. Yeah.
Yep.
Temp, can you tell me what your answer is going to be?
I just, the thing about a Shaolin Monks 2 is the same reason why I'm not big on story modes. I'm sure it'd be a great game, but even if they give me all the things I want, which is like the Dark Souls open world style, even if they give me all the execution ceilings so I can do all this cool Devil May Cry shit, one day I'm going to beat that game and it's going to be over and maybe I'll revisit it in 2 years. And I just... a fucking competitive version of UMK3 would just, oh man, it would be so tight. And just watching like Czech and fucking, Shock come out to do UMK3 tournaments and realize they're still not nearly as good as Ryo, like that would be a lot of fun for me. Like, I think just to breathe life back into that legacy, because let's be real, like the only reason why those games were competitive is because the meta was so insular around this small group of people. I feel like if like Flo and Justin Wong and Daigo all went to the UMK3 tournaments, it would just be like fucking instant air fireballs and a bunch of smoke bullshit. I don't really think the game's meta would hold up if a lot of people played it more than what we had originally. So to breathe life permanently in that legacy so it's functional and it's mostly balanced and like people can kind of pick at least, like, the reason why Third Strike had so much longevity is because even though Chun-Li and Yun were busted, I would argue Yun more than Chun-Li, although Chun-Li was probably technically better. Like, the top 10 are so buff. They're so fucking swole. So you can kind of make a competitive tournament scene out of that. I don't really think that's true of MK3, not just because of the balancing, because of the glitches. So I would like to see, like, a final version of UMK3, just like I'd like to see a final version of MK9. Like, I was pissed I didn't get one more balance patch, and that game would have been perfect. Yeah, Shaolin Monks, it's cool, but it's a firecracker. Once it's burnt out, like, I'm going to move on.
Now, keep in mind.
It's a YouTube video after that.
Keep in mind, Shaolin Monks 2, because I'm making it, is going to have versus mode online.
But is it going to be like the shitty Double Dragon style like they did in the old game? Or...
Oh, God, yes.
I don't know. That's not the selling point.
There's going to be a ranked. It's going to be amazing. It's going to be first to three. It's going to be sick.
I don't know if I want to play the fucking Pokken version of MK. I don't know if that sounds
if
good.
If you think about it, though, I mean, if they did a Shaolin Monks, you're in an open 3D world like that. If they did it, there's no reason why they couldn't make a versus mode. If the core gameplay of Shaolin Monks 2 was good enough, there's no reason why, if it was like Dark Souls or something like that, if they made it to that level of quality, there's no reason why you can't then make the versus mode on the level of, say, Tekken in sort of a 3D arena that you have ring outs and stuff.
I mean, yeah, like, yeah, I mean, yeah. Shaolin Monks 1 had a versus mode. It would be like that, but a little more...
Obviously much more polished and trying to still maintain a competitive nature to it than the first one
yes,
did. Yes,
that, and also online.
Yeah.
I don't think that had online. I don't know what the PlayStation 2 did online. Let's not talk about
it. Yeah. Deception and Armageddon were, like, the only two of those console-era games that had online.
I don't know, man. Shaolin Monks 2 online? Could be tight.
I'd like that. I'd also like more like environment and like interaction. Like I really like the how you could pick up objects in Shaolin Monks and like throw them at people. I think on online that would be pretty cool. A lot of more strategy.
I'd like just, it just, for just a more... change of pace. I just wouldn't want it for in place of the fighter. Like I would like it as like an addition to the cycle. Yeah. I wouldn't want it in place of the cycle.
Yeah.
Waiting 8 years for another versus MK game in between the last one would feel like forever.
Well, that's the thing. Like, NRS is not going to make Shaolin Monks 2 ever in any reality. It's never going to
happen. Yeah, they're not going to be the ones for sure.
I wish they'd make another Puzzle Fighter, though. I don't see why, any reason why that couldn't happen.
Puzzle Fighter was great, yeah.
That'd be easy, I would think.
Well, yeah, they can just put their mobile division on that. They got those guys downstairs working away right now. They're still making WWE content.
Like, maybe if you handle, like, if you hand that project to Rocksteady, they can make an action-adventure MK.
Yes.
All right.
I think so too.
We're ending it. It's done.
See? Man, that was a fucking good question. Why don't you guys come up with shit like this? Everybody
I do have a good question. Right now, I just don't know if we want to go another 15
to
answer.
Warrior Shrine, where you get hot, juicy content like this all the time. Tune in. Twice a year when it goes up.
If someone wants to play Street Fighter V with me, I'd love to play Street Fighter V.
This is getting pathetic. All of it. It's getting pathetic.
I just learned Sakura. I want to play video games.
Did you already stop recording?
No.
Oh, damn.
Wow.
Do you want me to?
It's up to you, man.
Well, I had another question, but I feel like it's one of those that's going to go on for another 15, so we might as well just call it good here.
Yeah, I'd write it down. We'll get to it next time.
Yeah, this was fun.
He wrote your question down.
I don't need to write it down.
Got it.
He's got A-plus memory.
We're ending the episode here, though.
Got it.
Peace.
Thanks for tuning in again, guys, and welcome back, Graveyard Shift. We will see you again in another year.
At least.
Yeah. Adios. Yeah, we could have done without that, though. Yep, see, this is what you were missing the whole time. Everything. I hope it was worth it. You asked for this. Remember that. You guys asked for this.